whenever
we will introduce in our this cell, sir, employment cell also, we will tell them about
okay,
this.
Okay, okay, yeah. So
what are the examinations and all, we will tell them.
Interested student can come
apply,
and join
yes.
this field.
Yes, field. Yes.
Because the librarian also are looking for the good new student who can take interest
yes.
and
work. Yes.
Even in this information technology period also,
yes.
the human touch is very important. Technology alone
yes,
cannot
yes. No,
anything.
No, no. Not only the technology, but
so
person is also important, sir, to
uh-huh.
get that information. We need a person, sir.
A person, sir.
yes.
Without,
yeah.
nobody can give
yeah,
proper
yeah.
directions.
Directions
that
for
a,
that. How to use that properly, the information technology should go in a proper way. So that a person who is expertise in that,
even
should
see,
be there.
In our car, Google Map and everything is there. But
yes.
even though we have to...
yes, we have to put our hands on the steering and drive to the GPS accordingly.
But even then sometimes we need help of someone on the road. Please
yes.
show me if
yes,
I want to
yes.
go in those places, how I can go.
Yes, GPS will say to right and left, so we have to move in with direction that we should be there. We have to ask a person around the road where to move, whether it
we
is a left
move.
Or right.
In
it's
that
needed,
sometimes
sir.
We realize, oh, this
yeah.
way is on this way, but GPS
yes,
showing
yes.
the direction on
sometimes
the
sometimes GPS will show you a long route also.
So this is the thing that is, I think, our original Indian tradition, our original culture, our value.
Yes.
Any technology cannot replace this.
No.
Any, never.
No, never.
So
we also facing this problem in online teaching also. We are not connecting with student emotionally.
Yeah.
We are only giving them a lecture, a dose of lectures daily, but whether they are taking it not, that we can't, we are not able to understand.
Hmm.
Whether students are really getting that, the problem, the content, what we are teaching them.
But even this, if I can give an example of this platform, just
yes.
now we are able to talk with each other. But even
yes.
the same thing happen as a present in your college. Suppose
yes.
we all today would gather in your college. The thing
yes.
would be different. Huh?
Yes, yes.
That's something really...
Yeah,
we cannot say
yes.
that ceiling at any way here in the online
no,
or technology.
No, yes.
So, madam,
students are not responding. We have no eye-to-eye contact. So
yeah.
whether we are not getting through it, that's a very great problem in this virtual platform.
And even
so
if
it's a boon for the science and technology,
yeah.
but then also.
And even
is,
if today we would visit your college, we see your class, your student, your campus,
yes, yes.
and our purpose is...
It's a feeling
just,
is very different.
Yeah,
it's really
something
is
different.
Very different.
Our purpose is must just come here and deliver
yeah.
our half hour
yeah.
talk.
Only we are boosting with a information, large amount of information
yeah.
gathering
yeah.
only
mm-hmm.
students are taking.
So overall gaining something is really different. That is the reason.
Yeah.
Let us know
yes.
it does not come from all direction. Even
yeah.
walking
yeah.
with someone.
The interior and the
someone,
yes,
some
students
some
are not getting the access
yeah.
completely and they are devoid of that.
Yeah, technology only provides the one purpose only, but the surrounding
yes.
purpose technology cannot help.
Yeah, the environment is very important.
Yeah.
Sir. The learning environment is very important.
Yeah.
Madam, I think we can start, madam, now.
Yes, sir. With the permission of Rajesh Lokhande, sir, is the convener of the program. So, shall we start the program? Lokhande, sir, unmute your mic. Sir, am I audible to you? Rajesh Lokhande, sir?
Yeah.
Yes, madam. Yes.
Yeah. Shall we
yes,
start, sir?
Haan, sir. Haan, madam.
Uh-huh. Okay, then.
Yes, yes.
Yes. Very good morning to all of you. So shall we start the program? Lokhande sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Unmute your mic.
No.
Sir, am I audible to you?
Yes, yes.
Rajesh Lokhande sir?
Yes, madam.
Yes, yes. Yes,
sir. Yes, sir.
Very good morning to all of you.
Yes, yes. No. Yes, yes.
Yes, yes.
Dr. Chikate sir, good morning.
Where is Chikate sir?
Yes.
Hello sir.
Good morning, madam.
Welcome, sir. Welcome on this platform, sir.
Thank you very much. It's my pleasure. Yeah.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir. Good morning. How are you?
Fine, sir.
Thank you.
Morning, Chikate sir.
Good morning, sir. Yes.
मैं
आपसे मिलने के लिए बहुत कोशिश कर रहा था लेकिन वर्चुअली मिल गए तो अच्छा है because I'm basically नागपुरियन.
Yes.
And my son was the student of NLU your law college.
Yeah.
After the 1 year, so he changed the college and now admission at the government law college at Mumbai. Now he is second year there. आप जैसे ही नागपुर में आ गए थे तो मुझे बहुत टेम्पटेशन हो रहा था कि कब मैं आपसे मिलूं कब आपसे लेकिन अच्छा लगा. मैं आते रहता हूँ नागपुर तो डेफिनेटली नेक्स्ट आई विल विजिट देयर. ना
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल सर, श्योर
फोन करके मैं आ जाऊंगा. हाँ, राज्य से मैंने फोन लिया है आपका. मेरे ख्याल से आज के प्रभात पांडे सर भी ज्वाइन हो गए मैडम.
हाँ ऑल हैव जॉइंड सर. शैल वी स्टार्ट सर? लोकंडे सर.
यस यस मैडम.
अनिल सर आपका वीडियो थोड़ा सेट कर लीजिए ना. आपका फेस ऊपर से
फिनिश दी.
जी करता हूँ.
हाँ बातुले सर गुड मॉर्निंग.
वेरी नाइस गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरीबॉडी एल्स ऑन द प्लेटफॉर्म. Yes. Welcome to the family of Dr. Ambedkar College, Diksha Bhavan, Nagpur, Maharashtra, India.
Yes.
And we do have a national level webinar today on the e-resources for academic excellence, NLIST and open access resources. Today is Monday, 11th January 2021, and you all are very eager to attend the very significant inputs given by the to be given by the subject experts on this virtual platform. This platform is being managed by TriStar Services from Nagpur, and they are offering very best services in case of Zoom subscriptions, YouTube Live, and many other things in case of virtual recordings, etc. So I welcome all the guests here. We are today accompanied by Dr. Prabhat Pandey, HOD and Librarian, Sarojini Naidu Government Girls PG Autonomous College and Bhopal, and President of Madhya Pradesh Library Association. Welcome on board, sir. We also have with us Dr. Suresh Jangeji, University Librarian and NAC Coordinator, Gulbarga University, Karnataka. And he is also a President of Karnataka University Librarians Association as well as Hyderabad Librarians Associations. We have with us our principal madam, Dr. Mrs. B. A. Mehre, and as a resource person, we have Dr. Anil Chikate, librarian, Kavyatri Bahinabai Chaudhary, North Maharashtra University, Jalgaon. And for the second academic session, a very well-known face in Nagpur, we have Dr. Shalini Lihkar, Associate Professor, Nagpur University, Nagpur. And for the valedictory function, we have Dr. Lagdir Bari, Deputy Librarian, Maharashtra University, Nagpur. The program is being managed and operated by Mr. Rajesh Lokhande, who is the librarian of Dr. Ambedkar College Central Library, and Mr. Prasanna Mu, who looks after the library in law section. So welcome everyone. I'm also accompanied by team members and my dear sir, the college. I have with me Rashid Moraskar, who is looking for the technical details. So let us begin with a formal opening of the webinar. And before we proceed further, as I was searching through one or two pages on how e-resources can be beneficial to one and all, and especially in case of teaching learning nowadays in the days of pandemic, I came across lots of material which served a very ready purpose and significance of the webinar, and I can't hold back myself reading a few of them. that the e-resources we have around us nowadays, the benefits, I'm reading one or two benefits only. The information preserves at standard interval and can be reserved always up to date in electronic media. So two things are very important. One is the standard interval, and it can be updated at any point of time, as many times as you want. Second is, it also ensures the smooth progress of replication into a new media and sharing of data also. That is very important. Because far out the days when we used to have all kinds of photocopying and Xeroxing, but nowadays at a single screen we are here, you know, we have enabled, I mean, the technology has enabled all of us to share, you know, thousands of pages on a single click. And that is quite the wonder of technology. In case of teaching learning and enriching the resources in library or the benefit of academics, we find that this is one of the best topics chosen by the national webinar. And we have the best resources today with us to talk on the topic. So first of all, let me invite Mr. Rajesh Lokhandeji, who is the librarian of the Central Library of Dr. Ambedkar College, to have some opening remarks on the national webinar. Rajesh Lokhandeji.
Thank you, Dr. Shailesh, sir.
हेलो
तथागत गौतम बुद्ध और भारत रत्न डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब अम्बेडकर इनको विनम्र अभिवादन परम पूज्य डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब अम्बेडकर स्मारक समिति के अध्यक्ष आदरणीय भदंत आर्य नागार्जुन सुरेश ससाई जी स्मारक समिति के सचिव आदरणीय डॉक्टर सुधीर पुल्येले सर स्मारक समिति के सभी सम्मानीय सदस्य इस नेशनल वेबिनार के प्रमुख अतिथि आदरणीय डॉक्टर प्रभात कुमार पांडे सर लाइब्रेरियन और एचओडी डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ लाइब्रेरी एंड इंफॉर्मेशन साइंस सरोजनी नायडू गवर्नमेंट गर्ल्स ऑटोनॉमस कॉलेज भोपाल और मध्य प्रदेश लाइब्रेरी एसोसिएशन के अध्यक्ष कीनोट स्पीकर आदरणीय डॉक्टर सुरेश जांगे सर यूनिवर्सिटी लाइब्रेरियन और नैक कोऑर्डिनेटर गुलबर्गा यूनिवर्सिटी गुलबर्गा कर्नाटका President Karnataka University Librarian Association Karnataka President Hyderabad Karnataka Librarians Association Resource Person Adarniya Dr. Anil Chikate Sir Director Knowledge Resource Center Kavitri Bainabhai Chaudhary North Maharashtra University Jalgaon Resource person, Adarniya Dr. Shalini, Library and Information Science, Rashtra Sant Tukoloji Maharaj, Nagpur University, Nagpur. Samarup Samarambha ke Pramukh Atithi, Adarniya Dr. Lagdir Rabbari Sir, Deputy Librarian, Maharashtra Law University, Nagpur. Chairperson, Adarniya Dr. B.A. Mehre Madam, Pracharya, Dr. Ambedkar Mahavidyalay, Dikshabhoomi, Nagpur. Dr. Ajay Kumar Agashe Sir, श्री आतिश मिश्राम सर डॉक्टर रामदास लीतकर सर वेबिनार एडवाइजरी कमेटी के सभी सम्मानीय सदस्य महाविद्यालय के सभी उप प्राचार्य नैक कोऑर्डिनेटर डॉक्टर हेमा मेनन मैडम डॉक्टर शैलेश बहादुरे सर डॉक्टर प्रतिमा लोखंडे मैडम डॉक्टर अनिता तिरपुड़े मैडम इस नेशनल वेबिनार के ऑर्गेनाइजिंग सेक्रेटरी श्री प्रसन्न मूल सर टेक्निकल एक्सपर्ट श्री आशीष मोरासकर श्री कमलेश खैरकर ग्रंथालय विभाग के सभी कर्मचारी वर्ग और इस नेशनल वेबिनार से जुड़े देश के विभिन्न राज्यों के सभी पार्टिसिपेंट्स मैं राजेश लोखंडे लाइब्रेरियन डॉक्टर अंबेडकर महाविद्यालय दीक्षाभूमि नागपुर आप सभी का हार्दिक स्वागत करता हूँ आज के नेशनल वेबिनार का टॉपिक है ई रिसोर्सेज फॉर अकेडमिक एक्सीलेंस एनलिस्ट एंड ओपन एक्सेस रिसोर्सेज इलेक्ट्रॉनिक संसाधन ई रिसोर्सेज डिजिटल प्रारूप में इलेक्ट्रॉनिक रूप से सुलभ सामग्री है। ई रिसोर्सेस के उदाहरण के रूप में लेख, ऑफलाइन पत्रिकाएं, ई जर्नल्स, ई बुक्स, ई थीसिस, डाटाबेसेस, वेबसाइट्स, पोर्टल, गेटवे, ब्लॉग्स आदि शामिल हैं। ई संसाधनों में समाचार पत्रों, शब्दकोशों और विश्वकोशों के साथ साथ इमेजेस और कई अन्य वस्तुओं के लेख भी शामिल हो सकते हैं। भी चुनौती को स्वीकार करना होगा। शोधकर्ताओं और ओपन डिजिटल विरासत के लिए और सभी उपयोगकर्ताओं के लिए खुले पहुंच का भविष्य असंभव नहीं है। दुनिया के ज्ञान को ग्रह के प्रत्येक नागरिक के लिए सार्वजनिक रूप से सुलभ कराना होगा। खुली डिजिटल विरासत के बारे में हमारा उद्देश्य सबसे महत्वपूर्ण अंतरराष्ट्रीय और राष्ट्रीय परियोजनाओं के बारे में जानना है, जैसे कि द यूरोपियन लाइब्रेरी, द वर्ल्ड डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी, गुटेनबर्ग प्रोजेक्ट, गूगल बुक्स, हाथी ट्रस्ट डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी, अमेरिका की डिजिटल पब्लिक लाइब्रेरी, इंटरनेशनल चिल्ड्रन लाइब्रेरी, द लाइब्रेरी ऑफ कांग्रेस डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी, फ्रेंच नेशनल लाइब्रेरी, चीन की नेशनल डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी आदि। भारत के संदर्भ में बोलना है तो डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी ऑफ इंडिया इत्यादि परियोजनाएं महत्वपूर्ण है। लाइब्रेरी और ई रिसोर्स सेंटर के प्रमुख उद्देश्यों में उपयोगकर्ताओं के लिए किसी भी समय संसाधन सदस्यों और विद्यार्थियों को शिक्षण और सीखने की जरूरतों में सहयोग करने के लिए सूचना सेवाएं प्रदान करना, विभिन्न प्रारूपों में प्रासंगिक जानकारी की विस्तृत श्रृंखला को पहचानना, हासिल करना और उपलब्ध कराना है। COVID-19 के परिप्रेक्ष्य में ई रिसोर्सेज की भूमिका, जैसा कि आप सभी जानते हैं, पूरी दुनिया में COVID-19 महामारी के चलते अधिकांश सरकारों ने सभी शैक्षणिक संस्थानों को अस्थायी रूप से बंद कर दिया है। इन राष्ट्रव्यापी आकस्मिक ज्ञानबंदी ने दुनिया की 90% छात्र आबादी को प्रभावित किया है। सभी देशों में स्थानीयकृत ज्ञानबंदी ने लाखों अतिरिक्त शिक्षार्थियों को प्रभावित किया है। COVID-19 संकट ने डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी के कई लाभों को सक्षम तरीके से सामने लाया है। वास्तव में डिजिटल पुस्तकालयों ने मानव विकास को बढ़ावा देने के लिए अपनी क्षमता का प्रदर्शन किया है। एक आपातकालीन प्रतिक्रिया के रूप में यूनेस्को ने वैश्विक शिक्षा गठबंधन शुरू किया है, ताकि देशों को अपने सर्वोत्तम दूरस्थ शिक्षा प्रथाओं को बढ़ावा देने में मदद मिले। दुनिया के प्रमुख ई पुस्तकालयों के आंकड़े उनके सांस्कृतिक महत्व की गवाही देते हैं। उदाहरण के लिए यूरोपियन यूनियन डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी EUDL अपने आधे मिलियन उपयोगकर्ताओं को लगभग 58 मिलियन डिजिटल सामग्री तक हर साल पहुंच प्रदान करता है। भारतीय संदर्भ में राष्ट्रीय डिजिटल लाइब्रेरी ऑफ इंडिया NDLI ने खुद को देश के सबसे बड़े ऑनलाइन शिक्षण मंच के रूप में स्थापित किया है। 48 मिलियन से अधिक ई पुस्तकों और विषयों का ज्ञान उत्पादों के लिए एक प्रमुख प्रवेश द्वार है। NDLI के आज लगभग 3 मिलियन नियमित उपयोगकर्ता है। एनलिस्ट परियोजना इम्प्लीमेंट सेंटर में स्थापित सर्वर के माध्यम से कॉलेजों और अन्य लाभार्थी संस्थाओं के तक पहुंच प्रदान करती है। कॉलेजों के अधिकृत उपयोगकर्ता अब ई संसाधनों तक पहुंच सकते हैं और उनके द्वारा आवश्यक लेखों को प्रकाशक की वेबसाइट से सीधे डाउनलोड कर सकते हैं, क्योंकि वे इम्प्लीमेंट सेंटर में तैनात सर्वर के माध्यम से अधिकृत उपयोगकर्ताओं के रूप में विधिवत प्रमाणित है। इस विषय पर एक विशेष सत्र का आयोजन इस वेबिनार में रखा गया है, जहां इसके विस्तृत उपयोग के बारे में आप निष्कर्ष के रूप में, हालांकि हम सब जानते हैं कि लाइब्रेरी की भूमिका सामग्री तक पहुंच प्रदान करने से परे फैली हुई है, जैसा कि यूनेस्को इफ्ला मैनिफेस्टो सिफारिश करता है, उन्हें बौद्धिक संपदा अधिकारों के बारे में जागरूकता भी बढ़ानी चाहिए। सांस्कृतिक विरासत करना होगा कि वंचित समूह पहुंच की समानता का आनंद ले। वैश्विक स्तर पर आभासी पुस्तकालय, दस्तावेजों, विरासत को संरक्षित करने के प्रयासों की अग्रिम पंक्ति में है। और अंत में मैं इस वेबिनार से जुड़े सभी पार्टिसिपेंट से अनुरोध करना चाहूंगा कि वे आज के वेबिनार में आमंत्रित मुख्य अतिथि, कीनोट स्पीकर और रिसोर्स पर्सन को ध्यानपूर्वक सुने, उनका निश्चित ही हमें फायदा होगा। इसके साथ ही मैं अपने शब्दों को विराम देता हूँ। धन्यवाद।
थैंक यू वेरी मच सर। मिस्टर राजेश लोखंडे हैज एड्रेस्ड की एरियाज एंड ऑल्सो एक्सप्लेन्ड हिज रोल वाइल ही फ्रेम्ड द टॉपिक फॉर नेशनल वेबिनार एंड इट सीम्स दैट ही हैज डन अ नाइस होमवर्क बिफोर ही केम टू अ कंक्लूजन that this should be a particular topic for a webinar. Thank you very much again. And on the timeline, we have next, according to the agenda, is Dr. Prabhat Pandeyji, HOD and Librarian, Sarojini Naidu, Government Girls, PG Autonomous College, Bhopal, and President of Madhya Pradesh Library Association. But before we proceed further, I take this opportunity to introduce Dr. Prabhat Kumar Pandeyji formally to this gathering. Dr. Prabhat Kumar Pandey is a librarian and head of the Department of Library and Information Science in Sarojini Naidu Government Girls PG Autonomous College, Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. He's serving there from 2013. He's also holding the position of President of MP Library Association. He did his PhD in Library and Information Science from Dr. H.S. Gaur University and a PG in three different subjects. He is also a recipient of Best Librarian Award 2016 at Thailand, LPA Best Academic Librarian Award in 2017 at Goa University, Goa, and he was also felicitated by Ranganathan Society for Social Welfare and Library Development and BIMTEC for his outstanding contribution for upliftment of library professionals in Madhya Pradesh. He is an expert of library automation, information retrieval, institutional repository, and digital library open source softwares. He has organized 4 national seminars and workshops on library automation and research methodology. He is an editor of International Journal of Information Librarian Society and chief editor of e-Invention, an international multidisciplinary journal with ISSN number, and he has authored 10 books and published 112 research papers in different indexed journals. He is associated with teaching and research of library and information science since last 15 more years and is a life member of ILA, IAS, LIC, SIS and other professional associations. Okay, and he has also visited China and Thailand to deliver special lectures on LIS education. Welcome, sir. And I request you to begin with your address to the gathering on this occasion of national webinar. Dr. Prabhat Kumar Pandeyji.
Thank you so much, Dr. Shailesh ji, to introduce me. Before I start, I wish to thank Dr. Mrs. B.A. Meher, Principal, and Dr. Ambedkar College, Diksha Bhumi, Nagpur, and Dr. Rajesh Lokhande, Librarian of this college, and entire team behind this webinar. Thank you so much for inviting me. Today's keynote speaker, Dr. Suresh Jange, resource persons, Dr. Anil Chikate, Dr. Salini Lehitkar, Dr. Lagdhir Reveries, library professional, dear students. I wish to again thanks for the library of Ambedkar College for organizing a national webinar on e-resource for academic excellence, enlist and open access resources. It's the need of the time. This theme is very much relevant, and this national webinar will help all the LIS professionals and academics at large. As we know that electronic resources are very much needed for academic excellence. Electronic resources included e-journal, e-books, and e-databases. We all are familiar with the fact that Enlist program is run by InfluNet Center, Gandhinagar. all government aided college covered under the UGC Act are eligible to access e-resources through enlist program, including universities also. In this program, through eSoch Sindhu, more than 6,000 plus journals, international and national, available, 1.64 lakh e-books, and NDL e-books, more than 6 lakhs available. So it's beneficial for basically for college or university librarians, because we have a lack of funds, that's why it is very nominal cost. If you have a member of 2F and 12B, it cost I think 6,000 around. So it is also covered non-aided college except agriculture, engineering, management, medical, pharmacy, dentistry, and nursing can also get benefit from the enlist program by joining the program. Regarding open access resources, it is the duty of library professionals to spread awareness about such open access resources. Open access educational resources like NCERT ebooks, directory of open access journals, directory of open access books, Sodh Ganga thesis, NDL resources, etc. are very popular. But sometimes librarians need to populate their library websites with such resources and need to organize more and more webinar for this particular topic. So again, I would like to thank Ambedkar College for inviting me and giving me space in your webinar. Thank you so much. Not taking much time, because Suresh Jange, we are eager to wait Suresh Jange, listen to Suresh Jange sir. So, and other experts. So thank you so much. Thank you once again. Thank you.
Hello.
आवाज नहीं
संपर्क
खत्म हो गया सर का सर थैंक यू वेरी मच Moving ahead with the agenda of the national webinar, with the conclusion of a speech by the Chief Guest Dr. Prabhat Pandiji, we have further here Dr. Suresh Jange as keynote speaker. Dr. Suresh Jange, the university librarian and NAC coordinator, Gulbarga University, Karnataka. Okay, and I take this opportunity to have a formal introduction of Dr. Suresh Jange ji to this gathering. Suresh Jange ji is a university librarian and NAC coordinator. Basically, he started his career at Sterlite Industries, Vapi Silvasa, and in Deep Daman, and as a management executive and library science. He was awarded gold medal in BLISC and MLISC and obtained PhD in 2004. He also cleared his NET JRF examination and the ECDL certification, British Computer Society, CI for IT. He served earlier as ETD in Department of Electronics, Hyderabad, and Tata Institute of Social Sciences, Mumbai, and has 21 years of professional experience in the field. He is the coordinator of for NFINET Center for eShodh Sindhu at Shodh Ganga Projects, and a question point, Ask Librarian Service from OCLC USA, Plagiarism Check, Digital Library of India, and the coordinator of university. He has completed major research project funded by UGC on development of the content on traditional knowledge and folk wisdom of Hyderabad, Karnataka region in 2012. He was also coordinator for a digital knowledge project connecting 1,000 Gram Panchayat libraries in Hyderabad, Karnataka region in the year 2015-16. And also completed a project on open-air green library and RFID technology in the year 2019-20, just a year before. He has several research papers on different issues which have got enough significance in the field of library science to his credit. And he has received two prestigious international fellowships also. One is IFLA ALP Fellowship in 2007 to represent India, and he visited Victoria University in Wellington, New Zealand and Australia. Commonwealth Professional Fellowship for 2013 was the second prestigious international fellowship to him. And he worked in the University of East London, United Kingdom. 120 research papers and almost four books authored by him personally and five books edited with a team. And under his able guidance, 8 scholars have been awarded PhD from different universities. 18 candidates have been awarded MPhil and 4 are still working. At present, he is a council member of Indian Library Association, president of Karnataka University Librarians Association, and also a member of state level selection committee. He also received the Best Librarian Award from Government of Karnataka in 2012 and ILA Gidwani Deshpande Best Academic Librarian Award in 2017. So this is all about, I mean, there is much to read beyond this. Okay. But I think this introduction to Mr. Dr. Suresh Gangiji is a beautiful beginning of this webinar. I request Dr. Suresh Gangiji to begin with his address to the gathering. Dr. Jangi, sir.
Sir, very good morning. Is it audible?
Yes, yes.
Very good morning to all of you. Yeah. Honorable chairperson and principal of this esteemed college of Dr. Ambedkar College of Deeksha Bhumi, Dr. Mehra Madam. Chief guest of today's webinar and the most dynamic and renowned president of MPLA, Dr. Prabhat Pandeji. Resource persons, Dr. Anil Chikateji, Dr. Shalini Litika, Madam, Dr. Lagdare Rabbareji, and my good friend and organizer of this esteemed webinar, Mr. Rajesh Lokandeji, esteemed teaching and non-teaching fraternity of this great college of Deeksha Bhumi, and all the library professionals and participants of this webinar. Today, I am really blessed to be a part of this Deeksha Bhumi's Dr. Ambedkar College, because during 2017, we had a wonderful international conference which was organized by this esteemed college, which was more of a physical. And now today, I feel proud that I am a part of this webinar in the virtual mode, because of this corona. Okay. See, coronavirus or COVID-19 is one of the such a healthy in this buzzard, you know, the pandemic that has created to the entire world, which we have accepted because there is no alternative as such. See, ye corona aisa hai, ye jindagi haseen hai, isse pyar karo, abhi hai raat, to isse intezar karo, wo pal bhi aayega, जिसके ख्वाहिश है हम सब लोगों को, भगवान पर रखो भरोसा, ये कोरोना निकल जाएगा हमेशा. सो लेट अस नॉट वरी दिस अबाउट कोरोना वायरस. सी, कोरोना आज है कल नहीं है, नहीं तो दूसरा वायरस आ जाएगा, दूसरे नाम पे आएगा, उसका चिंता करने का जरूरी नहीं है. सी कोरोना, लेट मी टेल यू एज अ लाइब्रेरी साइंटिस्ट, एज अ लाइब्रेरी प्रोफेशनल, कोरोना इज नॉट ए चैलेंज. Okay, we have already accepted a challenge. See, what is the strength of librarianship is we have to convert this challenge into opportunity. There lies the strength of a librarianship. And we have converted this challenge into opportunity. That is the beauty funda of librarianship. And now, in spite of the lockdown, in spite of so many hazards, we the library professionals with utmost care and diligence are rendering our library services to reach to our user community in spite of lockdown by making efficient and effective use of information and communication technology. If you probably the library and information science education, which has completed more than 100 years of LIS education in India, but today probably we all the librarians, irrespective of the fact whether you were a university, college, school or whatsoever, we have been optimally utilizing almost online tools like Zoom or WebEx or other modes of technological gadgets, just with an intention to provide our users the best possible information services in the electronic mode. So that is a strength, you know, that is the opportunity given by this COVID-19, and we have been quite successfully utilizing it. For that, we should need to thank the Information and Communication Technology Gazette. See, information technology is one of the greatest innovation of mankind. See, we all have been making use of this technology, not as a fashion, but we have been using this to improve the efficiency and effectiveness of our library services so that we reach to our user community, right? See, this COVID-19 or the IT, see, the way we learn, the way we teach, the way we conduct research, the way we impart, the way we provide information to the user community. See, here, you know, it has almost changed now. Because of the technology, now we are in a position to provide information to our user community by just push of a button, by... so that the information is reached to our user community. See, information is a basic necessity of life. Information is a fifth need of a human being after air, water, food, and shelter. Information is a lifeblood of modern research. Without information, there cannot be any development. And we, the librarians, are the preservers of this information and knowledge for posterity and use. You see, we, the librarians, have the passion of identifying, selecting, acquiring, maintaining, and disseminating information to the user community. See, that is the strength. See, we are there to enlighten our society, and we deal with entire gamut of knowledge. We are not confined to one subject. We deal with all the subjects available in the entire human knowledge, okay, right from 00 to 999. So that's the strength of our librarianship, which is a service-oriented profession, and we the librarians are no less than anybody, even the medical profession. And even if somebody says we are also corona warriors, we the librarians are also as a corona warrior, because we also render, we enlighten the society with information even under this COVID-19, isn't it? Why can't we? See, we are no less than any profession, and ours is a service-oriented profession. We, you know, we follow under the principles and the laws enunciated by our great father of library science in India, Dr. F.R. Ranganathanji. And see, today, as I said to you, the challenges are bound to be there. Okay, so only thing is how librarians convert those challenges into opportunities. That's the strength of our librarianship. Today, because of impact of electronic publishing, we have seen that so plenty of electronic resources are available. Maybe electronic book, electronic journal, e-thesis and dissertations, electronic reports, newspaper, online. Almost all the printed resources which are available in the library, now it is made available online. Maybe it's a free, maybe it's a subscribe, maybe through consortia. See, today now the theme of the conference is Enlist, you know. See, Enlist is Enlist consortia. Of course, it's a purely meant for a college. And for a university, we are calling it as an e-show, the Sindhu Consortia. See, the strength of Enlist is, each and every librarian and a participant know that, yeah, our college is having an Enlist Consortia. We have a more than 6,000 journals and lakhs together of electronic books. Oh, badiya, bhaiya, ye to bahut acha baat hai ki humare paas bahut kuch hai. Magar the challenge for librarians is how many people, how many students, how many faculty are making use of this Enlist. And for that, what is the effort of a librarian? Ye poochna padega. Humare paas bahut kuch hai. Bade bade baat hai, vada pav khate hai. Humare paas bahut kuch hai, yaar. प्रिंटेड भी है, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक भी है, कंसोर्टिया वाइज भी है, फ्री रिसोर्स भी है, सब कुछ है, मगर यूसेज कैसा कर रहे हैं हमारा लोग, हमारा लाइब्रेरियन होके हम क्या एफर्ट्स कर रहे हैं, ये चिंता करने के जरूरी है. ओके, सो एनलिस्ट ऑल इज वन ऑफ द ब्यूटीफुल सोर्स. See, and you know, because I know sometimes it pains me also that हमारा past enlist में इतना lakhs together of books है, lakhs together of journals है, मगर भी हमारा faculty हमारे students they are not using it pinches a lot. वो pain करता है, हमको लगता है अरे यार तू librarian है, तू इतना UGC pay scale ले रहा है, वो हमारा तुम्हारा जो enlist consortium अगर नहीं ले रहे तो तुम क्या कर रहे हैं? See, the government of India is spending a crores together of amount and investing lot of amount to improve the quality and excellence of our faculty and students, but even then why they are not using? See, the fault not only lies with the librarian, but also the fault lies equally with the teaching faculty, and we are trying our level best to ensure that we optimize the usage of NLIFT consortia. अभी थोड़ा लोग ऐसे भी पागल लोग हैं, ऐसे बोलते हैं अरे यार एनलिफ्ट हमारे रिलेवेंट नहीं, हम कॉलेज है, हमको ये ई बुक अच्छा यूजफुल नहीं है, ये जर्नल यूजफुल नहीं है. अरे भाई तुम्हारा पास 6000 जर्नल दे रहे, तुम्हारे पास कि वो नॉट इवन ए फिक्स जर्नल फॉर यूजफुल टू यू, तुम्हारे पास लैक्स टुगेदर ऑफ ई बुक्स दे रहे हैं, उसमें एक 10 बुक भी रिलेवेंट नहीं है. अरे यार तुम यूज करो, जब तक तुम वो तुम उधर अंदर हम गिरते नहीं उधर वो इंडेक्स में जाते नहीं, हमको मालूम नहीं पड़ेगा. चुप हवा में बात करने का तो बहुत लोग करेंगे, एनलिफ्ट बहुत अच्छा है बल्कि थोड़ा लोग बोलते हैं एनलिफ्ट अरे यूजफुल नहीं है. अरे भैया जब तक आप यूज नहीं करेंगे तो आपको इसका दम नहीं मालूम पड़ेगा. See, we should be very happy that the government of India, the respective government of all different states are making lot of effort to provide you the very, very costly information. Yaar, he show the consortium. See, we have a Springer Link, Trailer and Francis, Oxford University Press, Cambridge University Press, annual review. Aar, yaar, tumhare paas yatna, yatna badiya, badiya electronic resources are giving. And not only that, JGate portal, Web of Science, Citation databases. 12,000 electronic journals for even free. These are all very, very costly. And I tell you, the single university or college, they cannot afford to spend not even a lakh together of amount, not even a thousandth of the amount. See, seeing this condition only, just to improve our NAAC accreditation, just to improve our quality and excellence, just to make our faculty to be and our university to be top around among the 100 of a world university, we wanted to be one. For that, to bridge the gap between the information required by our teaching faculty and research scholars, what our government is doing, they are spending crores together of amount here. Humko enlift diya na to issue the Sindhu consortia, which is again the part of enlift only. It's a new terminology. Hamar paas yatna diye hai, yaar hum log kyun use nahi kar rahe? Of course, we the librarians are making our sincere effort to ensure that it is being optimally utilized. But at the same time, teaching faculty, you have to also make your syllabus or a curriculum or a assignment in such a way that you link the electronic resources or the print books, print resources and the curriculum, so that the students or a research scholar go to the library, they use it, use the assignment. Okay, that's how we need to do it. ये तो कंसोर्शिया एंड शालिनी लितिकर अनिल चिकाटे साहब तो बोलेंगे इन डेप्थ. देयर आर लॉट ऑफ प्लेंटी ऑफ फ्री रिसोर्सेज आर देयर यार. फिर डायरेक्टर ऑफ ओपन एक्सेस जनरल, डायरेक्टर ऑफ ओपन एक्सेस जनरल, दैट विल आल्सो बी टॉट फाइन. सी, देयर आर प्लेंटी ऑफ साइंस जर्नल्स लाइक इंडियन नेशनल साइंस एकेडमी, दे ब्रिंग आउट लॉट ऑफ क्वालिटेटिव जर्नल्स व्हिच इज अवेलेबल फ्री फॉर अस, इट्स ओपन सोर्स. बिफोर दैट आवर हमारा डेफिडॉक बुलेटिन ऑफ डेफिडॉक Desktop Bulletin of Information Technology, that's available free. And NISCARE, our annals of Library Science and Documentation, and there are plenty of science journals which are made free. And under COVID-19, majority of the publishers have come forward to provide you the qualitative journal. Aray yaar, agar aap hum ek journal, ek foreign journal, if you want to subscribe to your college library or university library, we have to pay more than lakhs together. अरे यार इतना हमारा नसीब है कि हमको इतना फ्री रिसोर्सेस है और हमारा कंसोर्शिया है. सी, वी हैव टू मेक एन एफर्ट. हाउ मेनी लाइब्रेरीज और मेक हैव डेवलप्ड ए पोर्टल कॉल्ड फ्री रिसोर्स, यू नो, लेट अस, यू नो, वी हैव आवर ओन वेबसाइट, मेक अ लिस्ट ऑफ फ्री रिसोर्सेज विच आर अवेलेबल सो दैट अवर यूजर्स कैन ऑप्टिमाइज इट. Okay, and let us develop the faculty librarian collaboration. प्यार करना पड़ेगा यार. हम faculty लोग अगर नहीं आते हैं तो तुम उनको बुलाना पड़ेगा, भैया आ जाओ, चाय पिलाओ, इधर चाओ, चाय पियेंगे, आ जाओ. फिर something we need to do, some sort of networking. अभी हम क्या करते हैं कभी, और यार मैं चीफ लाइब्रेरियन हूँ, मैं यूनिवर्सिटी लाइब्रेरियन हूँ, मैं कॉलेज लाइब्रेरियन हूँ बोल के तुम चेंबर में बैठेंगे तो लोग कहाँ आएंगे? हम प्यार से मिलना पड़ेगा. ओके, सो दैट्स व्हाट ऑफ एन एफर्ट वी नीड टू डू फॉर फॉर so that we develop a tempo of the bondage of love, not only from the librarian to the teaching faculty, to the research scholar and our students. Jab hamara father of library science in India, Dr. Ranganathan ji bole hain, the moment the student enters into the library, he is a god, wo hamara bhagwan hai, unko thoda pyar se bulao, jo bhi hai usko poocho, अरे यार तुम हम ये कि हम लाइब्रेरी में बैठ के ये कॉर्नर में बैठ के लाइब्रेरी बोले तो नहीं चलेगा. सी वी नीड टू इंटरैक्ट विद अवर यूजर कम्युनिटी, सो देयर लाइज अवर स्ट्रेंथ. दैट्स व्हाई लाइब्रेरी इज अ सर्विस ओरिएंटेड प्रोफेशन एंड लाइब्रेरी साइंस इज जस्ट लाइक अ मेडिकल प्रोफेशन. दैट्स व्हाट आई हैव टोल्ड यू, वी आर ऑल्सो लाइक कोरोना वॉरियर्स. ओके, वी नीड टू डू इट. बोलने से अभी मैं जितना बोलता हूँ ये बड़े बात, ये तुम जब तक हम लोग प्रैक्टिकल नहीं करेंगे कुछ जमता नहीं है, कुछ हो जाएगा नहीं. देर आर लॉट ऑफ सब्सक्राइब्ड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कंटेंट यार, इफ यू आर कॉस्ट, इफ यू कैन अफोर्ड टू पे द अमाउंट यू सब्सक्राइब. फॉर एग्जाम्पल एवरीवन इज टॉकिंग अबाउट प्लेगरिज्म, हमारे पास क्या है, फ्री मुफ्त में क्या दिया है, उर्कुंड दिया है. उर्कुंड बोलते हैं यार इट्स अ यूरोपियन वे, नहीं चलेगा, तुम पैसा है ले लो टर्निटिन, कैन वी अफोर्ड टू बाई टर्निटिन, यू टेक टर्निटिन. देर इज अनदर सॉफ्टवेयर कॉल्ड ड्रिल बिट, आई थिंक दिस कंटेन्स 17 रीजनल लैंग्वेजेस. ये उर्कुंड ट्री और टर्निटिन इट्स ओनली द रीइंफोर्स टूल व्हिच ओनली चेक्स ओनली फॉर इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज. देयर इज अनदर सॉफ्टवेयर कॉल्ड ड्रिल बिट व्हिच चेक्स 17 रीजनल लैंग्वेजेस, मराठी में चेक करेगा, हिंदी में, कन्नड़ा में, सब कुछ चेक करेगा. दैट्स वन ऑफ द ब्यूटीफुल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक टूल दैट वी कैन सब्सक्राइब फॉर दैट. There are a lot of, you know, as a librarian, you know, we are developing our institution repository. What if this is nothing but the e-content only, electronic resource only, which we are digitizing, maybe a question paper or a rare material, we are digitizing and trying to put on our server by making use of a DSpace or a e-prints. Okay, so that's, these are all the resources which we can really do it. And, you know, as a librarian or a teaching faculty, there are a lot of learning course materials which are available on the internet, maybe Indira Gandhi National Open University. Okay, see, there are plenty of learning course materials are available. E.P.G. Patashala. Okay, there are plenty of learning course materials which have been uploaded. See, only thing is our job is to promote it. Make, hum bolna padega, bhaiya, sab tumhara jo bhi course material chahiye, ye idhar hai, idhar padho. Itne bolega, hum jo kuch create karne ka jarur nahi, jo hai, unko, we should be a facilitator. That job we have to do with utmost care and with utmost passion. The passion is something which is required for a librarian. Of course, today abhi already Pandey Saab ne bola hai with national about National Digital Library of India. See, more than 3.8 crores of million means a lot of documents are there. Electronic book, learning course material, online journal, everything is there. See, that we need to promote. Are yaar, har bachche, har student, he or she is using mobile. Instead of using mobile for some other activity, tell him, go to your Play Store, download NDLI app and use whatever the information you want from the NDLI. Not only that, in Karnataka, in Department of Public Libraries, they have developed an app called e-Sarvajanika Granthalaya. They are providing a lot of Kannada e-books. And see, the registration, especially under COVID, now it has grown like anything. All because people nowadays, they wanted regional content. Marathi, as a Maharashtrian, I need Marathi. Yeah, as a Karnataka people, I need Kannada. See, that sort of a content is available, which is a free. See, our job is to make them available. And, you know, today, especially Kindle e-books. See, very recently, we have established in our library, so by procuring some 20 Kindle tabs and also Samsung tab, and wherein, see, we have paid only 2,000 rupees. Okay, 2,000 rupees plus, we subscribed Kindle content from the Amazon. Okay, the only one login password, you can use it for all your tab under the network. See, something, you know, we are talking about e-tab library. Yeah, practical kar sakte hain. Tumhare paas do hai, do rakho, ek hai, ek rakho, 10 hai, 10 rakho. Tab to kya 5,000 mein milega, 10,000 mein milega. You see, only thing is we have to do it. Hum jab naya kuch karte hain, to logo definitely tumko gaaliyan denge. Ye kya pagal aadmi hai? Wo logo physical library ko nahi aa rahe. Ye e-tap karta hai, kehte hai, remote access karta hai, bol ke. Logo to gaaliyan denge. Unko to kaam hai, gaalne dena. Wo chinta mat karo. As a librarian, you do. You start something new. See, that culture of technology, we have to create it. See, unless and until we create the technology of this culture, see, this, our students and faculty will not use. We all the time thinking that, wo kyun chahiye, ye kyun chahiye, arre wo kare to kaun use karega? Jab tak aap implement nahi karenge, to kaun use karega, yaar?
We have to start from where, we have to implement from where. And if we now, especially our students and the faculty, we have to have, especially for a competitive examination, a lot of course materials are available. That's for free also available, and subscribed content is also available. There are mobile applications for also available. One example is Copy Kitab. Have a look at the portal. Okay, you can subscribe all the competitive examination you are student. See, for preparation of IAS or KAS, KPSC or MPSC, banking, railway, LIC, whatever the competitive examinations are there, all those course material we have to provide to our students and the research scholar. We wanted to bridge the competitive edge of our students and research scholar and also faculty, so that they pass the competitive examination, they become the IAS officer. For that, our role is very important. Hum nahi to kuch nahi, kyunki hum log, we are the people, we are the librarian who empower our society with knowledge. अभी एक बड़ा आदमी कौन तो बना है, तो वो लाइब्रेरी के बिना बड़ा नहीं होगा यार. वो हमारे लिए, हम लोग सर्विस दे रहे, हम लोग राइट इंफॉर्मेशन दे रहे, उसके लिए वो बड़ा आदमी हो गया है ना. सी दैट, यू नो, वी हैव टू टेक इट वेरी सीरियसली, नॉट वेरी कैजुअल. ओके, सी आवर चैलेंज आई वाज टेलिंग यू इज दैट देयर इज, सी द थीम इज लाइक इलेक्ट्रॉनिक रिसोर्सेस, मे बी एनलिस्ट और फ्री रिसोर्सेस और व्हाटएवर. Our challenge is not the availability of electronic resources, but what efforts we are doing to promote the usage of electronic resources. There lies the funda. Okay, see, for that we have to do it. And very recently, there is a one concept called One Nation One Subscription. There were a lot of discussion. वो अच्छा है बुरा है? अरे यार, जो अच्छा है बुरा है नहीं, कुछ भी नहीं रहता है. It is the attitude of our people to accept or not. See, when there is a concept called one nation and one subscription, kya hai, matlab kya hai? Arre yaar, because our government of India, especially Ministry of Higher Education, they are bothered about the quality of the educational institutions available in the India, maybe colleges or universities or research institutes, they want to improve the quality. Our scientists should not suffer for want of a quality information, for want of a very costly information which is not accessible, which is a paid one. So उसके लिए क्या कर रहे हैं गवर्नमेंट? दे आर वॉन्टेड टू पे द अमाउंट टू एंड मीट एंड दे वॉन्ट टू नेगोशिएट विद द पब्लिशर, गेट ऑल सॉर्ट्स ऑफ क्वालिटी पब्लिकेशन, क्वालिटी साइंटिफिक जर्नल्स, एंड दे वॉन्ट टू प्रोवाइड फ्री टू अवर पीपल, अवर स्टूडेंट्स, रिसर्च स्कॉलर्स, टीचिंग फैकल्टी. दैट इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ वन नेशन एंड वन सब्सक्रिप्शन. अरे यार, वो ले लो, वो लोग हमको दे रहे हैं, हमारा क्या क्या, हमारे फैसिलिटेटर है, एंड डू यूर जॉब यार, प्रमोट इट. तो कभी भी टालियां दो हाथ में चलते हैं यार, एक हाथ में नहीं. हम और फैकल्टी मिल के काम करें, तो जो भी इलेक्ट्रॉनिक रिसोर्स है, जो भी कलेक्शन है, दैट वी कैन डू वंडर. एंड आवर करिकुलम शुड बी इंटीग्रेटेड विथ आवर मीन्स आवर लाइब्रेरी थिंग ओनली. नॉर्मली क्या हो जाते, एकेडमिक काउंसिल रहने दो, ये जो करिकुलम जब फ्रेम करते हैं, लाइब्रेरी को छोड़ देते हैं. अरे लाइब्रेरी को क्या मालूम है यार, मैं फिजिक्स आदमी हूँ, मैं केमिस्ट्री आदमी हूँ, उसको क्यों बुलाना है? अरे भैया, तुम केमिस्ट्री है, साइंस है, सोशल साइंस है, तुम लाइब्रेरी को इन्वॉल्व करो, वो आपको भी समझेगा. अभी देखो, एवरीवन वांटेड टू सर्च इलेक्ट्रॉनिक रिसोर्सेस, प्लेगरिज्म है, हाउ टू पब्लिश द आर्टिकल है, अब रेफरेंस मैनेजमेंट टूल है. हर डिपार्टमेंट को वो होना चाहिए. उसके लिए किनका पास दम है वो बोलने का? ये लाइब्रेरियंस का पास दम है. तो सी, वी नीड टू हैव अ कोलैबोरेशन. अगर आपको टीचिंग फैकल्टी अगर नहीं बुलाता है, तो तुम बुलाओ यार, तुम मेंटेन रिलेशंस. दैट इज, दैट्स व्हाई फैकल्टी लाइब्रेरियन कोलैबोरेशन इज वेरी मच रिक्वायर्ड. ओके, सी, फ्रॉम दिस वी कैन रियली, यू नो, प्रमोट अवर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक रिसोर्सेस टू अ मैक्सिमम एक्सटेंट. अदर इफ इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल, एंड टुडे दिस इज, वी आर ऑल वरीड अबाउट NAC. ओके, बिकॉज वी वॉन्टेड, आजकल क्या हो रहा है, अगर समझो NAC में तुम्हारा बी ग्रेड आया, सी ग्रेड आया, तो किनको गालियां देते हैं? पहला गालियां देते हैं लाइब्रेरियन को. अरे यार, थोड़ा में मिस हो गया यार, मेरा लाइब्रेरी अच्छा नहीं था, मेरा लाइब्रेरियन अच्छा नहीं था, उसके लिए मुझे कम मार्क्स आ गया. बोल के लोगों को तो क्या, ब्लेम करना अच्छा है, ब्लेम करते नॉर्मली, तो उसके लिए वी शुड नॉट गिव एन अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर एनीबडी. अवर लाइब्रेरी तुम्हारा, आई अंडरस्टैंड, there are college libraries, there are colleges, there are small other, even from universities, they don't have infrastructure. वो कभी मैं कॉलेज लाइब्रेरी थोड़ा कॉलेज लाइब्रेरी में देखता हूँ क्योंकि आई हैव अ प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द एसोसिएशन आई ऑल्सो विजिट ऑल द डिफरेंट कॉलेजेस कभी लगता है अरे यार मैं इतना बात कर रहा हूँ बट फिजिकली व्हेन आई गो टू द कॉलेजेस कभी बैठने के लिए चेयर नहीं है टेबल नहीं है एक ही आदमी रहता है थोड़ा रैक में थोड़ा बुक रहता है ये हमारा जो लेक्चर है तो क्या काम आएगा लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड दैट we the Indians live we have to work within the limitations of the system jo bhagwan ne diya hai jo bhi hamara paas hai within that you have to do you have to provide the best possible services kabhi bolte hai college library mein sir mere paas mujhe computer nahi diye hamara principal are yaar tumhara computer to nahi diya na chhod do goli maro tumhara paas kya hai laptop khareed karo yaar tumhara UGC pay scale hai ek laptop lekar aa jao जो भी फ्री रिसोर्स है लिंक करो क्वेश्चन पेपर तुम स्कैन करो तुम्हारा मशीन में यूज करो यार तुमको कुछ नहीं चाहिए तुम्हारा एक जो लैपटॉप में काम करो तुमको बाद में बोलेंगे ये लैपटॉप लाइब्रेरियन बोल के कुछ तो कुछ करो यार जो है करो नहीं है बोल के कभी भी हम लोग क्या करते हैं सर वो नहीं है ये नहीं है अरे कितना जिंदगी भर कितना मरमर करना पड़ेगा है ना दिस इज गोइंग टू बी देयर वी द इंडियंस आर नॉट बॉर्न विद अ गोल्डन स्पून ये तो प्रॉब्लम रहता है जो भी है जितना भी है वेतना भी है हम खुशी होके विथ पैशन वी हैव टू रेंडर अवर सर्विसेज दैट इज द फंड ऑफ अवर लाइब्रेरियनशिप यार ओके एंड इन द नैक आई टेल यू टुडे बिकॉज मेजॉरिटी ऑफ द यंगर लाइब्रेरियंस व्हिच आई एम लुकिंग एट सी ऑलमोस्ट ऑल इन अवर इंडिया दे हैव बीन गिवन अ इंपॉर्टेंट रोल एज अ नैक कोऑर्डिनेटर आईक्यूएफए कोऑर्डिनेटर आईटी कोऑर्डिनेटर क्यों दे रहे लाइब्रेरियन को because they understand that the librarians of today's arena they are very very talented very very skilled uske liye wo logon ko wo responsibility diya hai when they have given the responsibility we should prove beyond doubt that we are no less than anyone hum kisi se kam nahi okay that is what actually the smart librarianship is all about okay see the smart librarianship aisa hai yaar we have to be aajkal ke sometimes it pains also today kya ho gaya culture everyone is using only computer are tum computer ke piche baith ke kaam karenge to logo ke samne kaun jayega for I am a IT librarian are tu IT librarian nahi bhaiya IT karo service do magar kabhi tum aage sir users ke paas bhi jao thoda baat karo pyar karo aisa karo तुम ज्यादा एवरीवन वांटेड टू इंस्टॉल डी स्पेस एवरीवन वांटेड टू इंस्टॉल द रिमोट एक्सेस अरे तुम बहुत कुछ करते करो बट एट द सेम टाइम इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी नॉट ओनली द सॉल्यूशन यार यू शुड बी ट्रेडिशनल यू शुड बी आईटी लाइब्रेरियन यू शुड बी ह्यूमैनिटेरियन आदमी पहला है उसके लिए सर्विस बात करो अच्छा से बात करो अगर तुम्हारा पास कौन तो यूजर आके तुमको पूछा ये इलेक्ट्रॉनिक जर्नल समझो इलेक्ट्रॉनिक बुक समझो नहीं तो प्रिंट बुक समझो अगर तुम्हारा पास नहीं है रही तो भी प्यार से बोलने का नहीं है ओके वो प्यार कैसे बोलने का वो जब आएगा तो ये आंसर में आई वॉन्ट दिस आर्टिकल बोल के जब तुम बोलेगा इफ इट इज नॉट अवेलेबल इन फ्रंट ऑफ दैट यूजर यू शुड मेक ए फोन कॉल टू अदर लाइब्रेरियंस इन द कंट्री who are very very cooperative bola sir mera paas ek user mera student aaya ek user aaya hai unko ye book chahiye ye article chahiye ye online journal chahiye aapka paas hai kya bol ke aap puchna padega tum do teen baar phone karo agar mile to acha nahi mile to bhi acha baad mein usko kya lagega are yaar mera library kitna shana hai yaar bahut bade aadmi hai wo ye dekho itna network hai usko wo maharashtra mein nagpur mein baith ke delhi mein phone kiya karnataka mein phone kara usko network bahut acha hai see this is how ek bar jab user andar aayega tum usse pair se kuch diye to that will continue that will multiply wo bolega are yaar tum jao yaar udhar library ke paas jo bhi pucho wo sab dega tumko sab bolega see that is you know that's what we need to develop aajkal kya ho gaya zyada shanatan jaan ko khatra हम लोग बहुत शाणे हो गए इतना शाणतन नहीं चाहिए हमारे इंडिया को शाणतन कितना चाहिए उतना ही रहना चाहिए जो हमसे सर्विस मिल सकता है यूजर को वो अच्छा बस उतना ही ओके सो दैट व्हाट यू नो टुडे सी इफ आई वी गो ऑन टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस इज प्लेंटी ऑफ अ थिंग देयर आर प्लेंटी ऑफ अ टेक्नोलॉजीज आर देयर सी यू टॉक अबाउट for providing access to all the electronic resources maybe through NDI through maybe this NLIFT or eShowthesindhu or NDLI or any free resources Our efforts are very important, and a lot of technological developments are happening in our India. We are using, like earlier, we used to use only phone software or other software. Now it's a Koha, it's a web enabled. We have other platforms which we are using it for institution repository, for a remote access. We are using like a Shibboleth or any other. See, and RFID technology, chatbot technology, okay. And now we are also using the other part of technology for our users, right? Maybe a resource discovery. Everything is fine here. We ultimately, you know, the librarian cannot be a digital, cannot be a print. He should be both. Okay, he should be librarian, should be a good communicator. Librarian should possess a sound knowledge of library science. He should knowledge of a print resources and also knowledge of electronic resources. See, librarian is a multi-faceted personality. Okay, for that we need to do. Today, our attitude is very important for a librarian. See, zuban par mohar lagana koi bade baat nahi. Badal sako to badlo. Mere khayalon ko, that is what important for a librarian. Okay. So for that, with all the positive attitude, see, we don't need any certification from anybody. See, let us do our duty with utmost care and diligence, with a passion. Kaam karo aisa ki ek pehchan ban jaye. Har kadam aisa chalo ki nishan ban jaye. Ya yahi hai jindagi to har koi jeet leta hai yaar. Jo bhi hai, hum jeet lenge jindagi. जिंदगी जियो इस तरफ इस कदर की मिसाल बन जाए. दैट शुड बी आवर लाइब्रेरियनशिप. विद दिस, यू नो, लेट मी टेल यू, टुडे वी द लाइब्रेरियंस आर नो लेस देन एनीवन. वी हैव द कैपेसिटी टू प्रोवाइड इंफॉर्मेशन टू आवर यूजर एट द राइट टाइम. ओके, एंड वी हैव दैट पैशन towards the information to provide our youth services. Don't expect any certification or any shabashigiri from logon ka par nahi chahiye humko. Hamara jo kaam hai, hamara jo hai, jo responsibility humko bhagwan ne diya hai, principal ne diya hai, management diya hai, user ne diya hai. Hum kaam karenge, chale jayenge. That should be the positive attitude of a librarianship. Okay, with this, I acknowledge with a high sense of gratitude to our principal madam, Dr. Mehra madam, and all the Bante Sabji, and all the teaching, non-teaching, and user community of Dr. Ambedkar College of Diksha Bhumi. I am very blessed to be a part of this Diksha Bhumi College of Dr. Ambedkar Ji. And I thank all the participants for listening to. And finally, I once again, with wholeheartedly, thank you for giving me this opportunity to be part of this noble webinar. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Nice talk, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Jange, sir. Great, great. Thanks for this speech, which was very much.
Thank you, sir.
Lots of things, not only for the librarians, but for the teachers, students, learners, researchers. For everyone, it was a good, very, a very, very good address, and you have impressed all of us very highly. Very humble thanks for your speech. Okay, one thing I could say is that your speech has, you know, a very genuine appeal into it. Okay, and that appeal, we will try to commit ourselves to live that appeal, and will also make us able to make use, you know, maximum use of library resources. And this on behalf of the organizing team of this national webinar, I put across a very sincere note of thanks to your address. Thank you. Next is, we are also supported by our dear principals, Dr. Mrs. B. M. Mehra Madam. And on this occasion, I request that we have a dialogue with the participants. Dr. Mrs. B. M. Mehra.
Thank you, Shailesh, sir. Thank you, the chief guest of today's function webinar, that is Jange sir and Pandey sir. I thank you for your speech, and whatever information you have given, it's very great for the users, and really we are impressed for both of you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Very pleasant good morning to all. On behalf of Dr. Ambedkar College, Dikshabhumi Nagpur, I, Dr. B.A. Mehre, Principal, welcomes you all for today's national webinar organized by Department of Library, Dr. Ambedkar College, on a very recent and innovative topic of e-resources for academic excellence, basically emphasizing on enlist and open access resources. I first seek the blessings of two eternal souls, Tathagat Gautam Buddha and legendary revolutionary Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar. In today's unprecedented scenario of worldwide COVID-19 pandemic, this national webinar is an eye-opener for all academicians and administrators for academic excellence in education. We have with us a very learned team and experienced team from all corners of India to highlight on today's topic of science and technology, which is a boon and which disseminates the information technology for learners and users in very through the networking and through internet. Respected today's chief guest, Dr. Prabhat Pandey, HOD and librarian of Sarojini Naidu Government Girls PG Autonomous College, Bhopal. Guest of honor, Dr. Suresh Jange, University librarian, Gulbarga University, with two eminent resource persons, Dr. Anil Chikate from Kavyatri Behnabai University of Jalgaon and Dr. Shalini Leetkar, associate professor from RTMNU Nagpur University. I also welcome today's valedictory function guest speaker, Dr. Lagdir Rabari, sir, Deputy Library, Maharashtra Law University. Convener of the webinar, Mr. Rajesh Lokhande, Dr. Ambedkar College, and Organizing Secretary, Prasanna Mool, Assistant Library from Dr. Ambedkar College, Law. And on the all the participants who are on Zoom line and YouTube streamliners, all my dear friends, I once again welcome you all for today's webinar. Our college is established in the year 1964 by late Padam Shri Dada Saheb Gaikwad under the aegis of Param Pujya Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar Smarak Samiti, and with the leadership of R.S. Gavai President late and Sadananji Fuljale Secretary, nurtures this education society with handful of 300 students and transform into a magnificent institute at the hands of Dikshabhumi, at the holy land of Dikshabhumi, with a 5,000 student pursuing quality education in arts, commerce, science and law under the leadership of President Holy Bhadanta Arya Nagarjun Surai Sasai and prudent director, magnificent director of management studies, Secretary Smarak Samiti Dr. Sudhir Fuljale sir, a dynamic visionary for uncompromising accomplishments. Academic excellence is the primary and prerequisite of every educational institution in today's competent world. It is accredited by and enriched by resources and assets such as libraries, which plays a very pivotal role in shaping the dynamics of human beings. Libraries facilitate self-directed lifelong learning, and the array of resources man's quest for knowledge has led to create and accommodate tremendous amount of information which is valuable for entire mankind and transfer liable to preserve. Libraries have great metamorphosis in recent years. They have a great development, advancement in information technology, and have computer applications during these two decades have brought radical changes into very information gathering, storing, organizing, accessing, retrieving and conserving the information, and developing a new modes of scholarly communications. For recent development, novel tools are essential. A new online database has been created with an aim to help researchers all over India. The one more basic tools that are the innovative tools we have, enlist and open access online databases, which are run by InfibNet Consortia. Research articles, e-journal, e-books, all experts from various fields, enlist journals which are executed by UGC, InfoNet, Digital Library Consortia, and Indus AICT Consortia, these e-resources are very important for the student researchers, academicians from the college, educational organizer. The users can download articles from publishers' website and authenticated through servers deployed at InfliMed Center. Open access resources, the part of consortium ranging from completely closed subscription and only access to open, no barrier publications or publishing. Benefits of open access reserve, they are incredible and with a lower cost, great accessibility and better for long-term preservation of scholarly work. The librarian must explore, depends on the given access resources to store and existing resources and provide better information to the user community. And Jange sir, I am with you that not only sitting in the library, we should have the interaction with the academicians, with the administration, with the administrator, with the user, with the student, whatever e-resources, whatever resources we have in the library, they should go to disseminate with the users. So it's a very important, at most important, that this should go. Otherwise, we should not have in the law, this land of Holy Diksha Bhumi at Dr. Ambedkar College. We know the fascinating fact of Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar, who is without books, without library, not to be transcended from a deprived student scholar, from a legend, a barrister, without books, without libraries, without resources, he should not be a legend or an economist or a scholar on this land across the globe. So we should salute his on this Diksha Bhumi, a holy land of Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar, and the Ambedkarites all over the India and the globe should take footsteps of his and see and use these resources which are available in all the libraries and should accommodate and replenish or acquire their all knowledge from these libraries. We should use these e-resources. So it is utmost request from my bottom of my heart to all the users that they should go in hand with librarians, the libraries, they should visit the libraries, interact with them and take all the respective information from these databases. It's with this positive note, I thank you all the team, all the experts from libraries who are really a great expertise for these library, how these resources are to be used, what are NLIST, what are open access. Our today's resource persons will definitely throw light on this subject. And I think on this positive note, I end up my speech. Thank you.
Thank you very much, madam, for your wonderful address to the gathering. In the last during pandemic, Dr. Ambedkar College has organized more than a dozen webinars, one from each subject or at least an area of faculty with significance. And the college has great a tradition of touching subjects and topics from the current happenings. And find that the channel we have on YouTube has more than more than that subscribers who are regularly attending the webinars. That becomes very relevant. We can say that these are perhaps the best topics across the country which are chosen by the departments in the college. Madam has rightly said that we can follow the footsteps of great scholars and the lands. A holy land where we are all situated, Dr. Ambedkar College. The land is physically touched by the great revolution, Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar. And I am responsible for all of us here to follow the path of knowledge. And a combination between the learners, teachers, and library could be a wonderful to know and realize in due course of time. So thank you very much, madam. This is where we come to an end of the inaugural session of the national webinar. And I am bound in love and a great sense of gratitude and thanks to Dr. Suresh Jhangeji and Dr. Prabhat Kumar Pandeji, Dr. Mrs. B. A. Mehre, and convener Dr. Rajesh Lokhande, and Mr. Prasanna Mool, organizing secretary of the national webinar. Hereafter, we will follow two academic sessions, and the first session is by Dr. Anil Chikate, librarian, Kavyatri Bahinabai Chaudhary, North Maharashtra University, Jalgaon. So once again, I put across a very sincere note of thanks to everyone who was there in the inaugural session of the national webinar, and conclude. I'm handing over the proceedings of the first academic session to Ms. Anita Tirpure from Department of Education. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Welcome back. Now we are entering in the first technical session. A very good afternoon to Honorable Resource Person, Dr. Anil Chikate, respected principal, respected dignitaries, teaching and non-teaching staff from various distinct colleges and delegates. The chairperson for the first session is the Director of Knowledge Resource Center, Dr. Anil Nanaji Chikate. He is from Kavyatri Bahinabai Chaudhary, North Maharashtra University, Jalgaon. And the topic of his discussion is National Library and Information Services Infrastructure for Scholarly Content. A very warm welcome to you, sir. And thank you so much for accepting our invitation and sparing with us your valuable time today. It's my privilege to introduce our guest. Dr. Anil Nanaji Chikate is a director of Knowledge Resource Center from Kavyatri Bahinabai Chaudhary, North Maharashtra University, Jalgaon. He is working and is having a teaching experience as college librarian for 17 years and as a deputy librarian for 4.5 years, and as a faculty in library and information science for 15 years. He's having 25 years of experience in administration. His area of research is IT in library and information science and research methods in library and information science. A good number of students have been awarded PhD, and many students are still pursuing research under Sir's able guidance. He has been awarded as the Best Librarian of the Year 2008 and Best Director in Maharashtra State for Drama in the year 1999. About his academic achievement, he has written two books, Information Resources in Library, published by Shree Publishers, New Delhi, and second one is Information Initiatives by Government of India, published by Dutson Publishers. He has published 5 research papers in journal at international level, 13 papers at national level, and 6 papers at state and regional level. He has also edited 6 journals and proceedings. He has also organized 5 national workshops and has also contributed as a resource person in various seminars, conferences, workshops, and refresher course. He has completed a research project, Special Development Grant for Young Colleges during 10th Plan, sponsored by UGC, and evaluation with special reference to schemes related to library books and journals and library automation. His ongoing research project is Institutional Repository for Faculty of Social Sciences of North Maharashtra University, Jalgaon. With a long list of his achievement and glory, I would like to invite Dr. Anil Chikate to please address the audience. Sir, please put light on today's topic.
Thank you. Thank you, Anita Tirpure, madam. You have given to my introduction very nicely. Thanks.
Thank once you, again.
Good morning, all the dignitaries and all the registered participants. This is the national webinar organized by Dr. Ambedkar College, Dikshabhumi, Nagpur, on e-resources for academic excellence, enlist and open access resources. It's a very burning subject, and it is very essential for all the academicians, not only for the researchers, academicians means all the teachers and users also. And this national webinar, today's national webinar, chair, honorable chairperson and respected principal, Professor B.N. Mehre Madam. Today's keynote addressee, Suresh Jange sir. He is the University Library of Gulbarga, University of Gulbarga. Today's resource person, Dr. Shandlini Leedkar Madam, Professor, Department of Library and Information Science, Rashtrasanta Tukdaji Maharaj, Nagpur University, Nagpur. Today's chief guest and our best friend, Dr. Prabhat Pandeji, is the president of Madhya Pradesh Library Association. Personalities with us. Actually, he is the valedictory guest, but now he is with us from start today's from beginning. Dr. Lagdeer Ravir sir, he is the deputy librarian, National Law University, Nagpur. Today's national webinar convener and college librarian, Dr. Rajesh Lokhandeji. Organizing secretary, Mr. Prashant Mool. My friend, Dr. Shailesh Bahadureji. All the committee members and all the respected participants. As you know, this is about the end list. Can you give the share list link to me? For my PPTs, please.
Sir, you can share the screen.
Yes, yes.
Please. It's visible, sir. Sir, it's working.
Okay. It's audible?
Sir, you are audible and the screen is also visible. You have shared your screen.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Okay. So friends, I will discuss with you on access to e-resources available to NLIST program. You know very well all the today's Madam.
Chikate sir.
Okay. NLIST, all the researcher and academician, we know the India has a lot of initiatives provided by e-resources. So many consortia also they have provided by university, government of India. Before that, two types of consortia they have given for the researcher. One we can say UGC Infonet. Now we can say the change is there, eShodh Sindhu and NLIST also. ICSR, Agricultural University, and INDES also. So many consortia for the created for the researchers also. Okay, now today we will focus on the ENLIST only. So ENLIST is the provided by UGC ImpliNet, and ImpliNet centers very nicely they have given two consortia, UGC ImpliNet, that's called we call Shodhisindhu. And this Shodhisindhu is this consortia only for the universities, Indian universities, and ENLIST for colleges. Okay, apart from that, ImpliNet had so many initiatives given the services, OGS Import Portal, ICSR Data Services, EG Pathshala Services, Indian University Ranking, E-Content, Open Access, Consortia, SOL, INDCAT. So many initiatives taken by the ImpliNet. So we will discuss about the ENLIST program. So this ENLIST program is started as a project under NME ICT born 2010, and cross subscriptions with the INDES ICT also. This consortia is available to the INDES ICT also. And national and international recognition, not only for the state wise only, this is the recognition. And graduate and regularly scheme of the UGC ImpliNet Digital Library Consortia. So before starting, we can see here, access to content library consortia, our express Dr. A.P. Abdul Kalam sir, UGC ImpliNet Digital Library Consortia, he talk about good words about the ImpliNet and so in that ENLIST friends 8,500 journals and that are 424 members institutions included, 220 universities and 204 associate members funded by the UGC 2004 to 2005. This is statistic. And UGC ImpliNet 2003 index AICTs and 2010 it means ENLIST started. So from this ENLIST started, 15,000 journals, 10 databases, and so many e-books are also there. 7 lakhs plus 31,64 e-books are available, including in this ENLIST. So friend, this is the background. Just you know about all the participants and faculties know about the ENLIST. The project entitled National Library and Information Services Infrastructure and Scholarly Content. It stands for ENLIST. They graduated at the regular scheme of UGC under UGC ImpliNet Digital Library Consortia as college component. Is the merge into a Shodhisindhu now consortia for higher education only. And the ENLIST project use a highly innovative access model, provided access to 6,000 plus e-journals and around 1.64 lakhs all government aided colleges, as well as non-aided colleges also, they have provided through the proxy servers installed in like the ImpliNet center. This is the main homepage of the already we have talked about the how many resources including provided through the ENLIST. So now you can see there here 6,150 journals and this e-books, 3,522 members colleges, near about 6 lakhs e-books through the NDL, 98 colleges registered from the Odisha. And the features, college can register for the year. Colleges can create users themselves with the logging ID and access from the anywhere of anytime. So this is the good features of the endless. There is no bar ki you have to register from this day and from this month only. You can register anytime and anywhere, access from anywhere and anytime. All Indians colleges can register and get the access to the resources. So current status of the 27th July 2000, I have given this. So total colleges, 3,546 colleges already registered for the enlist. And apart from that, 12B colleges, 3,292 are there. Non-aided college, 234 are also there. And science college has 2,143. And not eligible colleges also, they have 1,016. So this is the statistic up to the 24th July. Friends, enlist implementation methodology simple and implement they have proxy service and 24 hours is open for the services and all publishers and publishers and subscriptions they have and their access. This mechanism also the very simply. So I have given here some slides to access the mechanism. So access to college in enable through authentications mechanism set up at Implement Center, of course. Access being the enable using EZ proxy as a mechanism to authenticate authorized users, enable them to access subscribe e-resources. So it is the very good for us. Friends, I have given the one chart here, electronic journals subscribed under enlist program. So you can see here, so American, I have given published countries and publishers here. So American Institute of Physics, lot of these publishers already published a lot of us, but in these programs we have given the 18 titles of journals to us through the enlist and 10 years back also. Not only the current, they have given the back also. Means archives also they have provided to you, us. Annual reviews, Economics and Political Weekly, Indian Journals, Institute of Physics, JSTOR, Oxford University Press, Royal Society of Chemistry, H.W. Wilson. So number of, this is the standard publishers. Ek bhi yaha substandard publishers nahi dikhega aapko. To ye enlist ne jo program apne college ko diya hai resources, ye standards hai. Means you know ki free hai ya kam supply mein hai to kaisa bhi chalega. कोई भी आपको मटेरियल दे रहे नो इट इज द वेरी स्टैंडर्ड एंड यूजफुल फॉर द रिसर्च पर्पस एंड टीचिंग पर्पस आल्सो सो अगर ये ई रिसोर्स पे अपन थोड़ी नजर डाल देंगे तो अपने को पता चलेगा कि कितना स्टैंडर्ड मटेरियल दे हैव गिवन टू अस एंड इधर अपने अगर ये जो फॉर्म्स देखा है सो 1996 से लेके भी आपको आर्काइव्स दिया है So it's a very good for college libraries. Now here electronic books. So e-books names I have given this here. E-library, Cambridge Book Online, Ibisco Hots Net Library, Hindustan Book Agency, Institute of South East Asia Studies, Oxford Scholarship Online, Springer Book, Taylor and Francis Book, My Library, Sage Publication, Open Access Net Library. So यहाँ भी ई बुक्स देन जब अगर पब्लिशर पे अपन नजर डालते हैं तो अपने को पता चलता है कि व्हाट्स द स्टैंडर्ड पब्लिशर्स ई बुक्स दे हैव गिवन टू वी हैव प्रोवाइडेड थ्रू द एंड लिस्ट ओके एंड हियर वी हैव गिवन द नंबर ऑफ बुक्स फ्रॉम द ईच पब्लिशर सो ई ब्रडी दे हैव गिवन 1,15,000 प्लस नियर अबाउट बुक्स from Ibisco also, Taylor and Francis, Springer, ये तो बड़े बड़े publisher है इनका एक title print version पे अगर अपन लेते हैं तो near about 25,000 to 50,000 एक ही book आता है but they have given this free or subscription basis to the endless and number how many they have Springer's they have given 2,300 titles and it's a good titles okay e-resources available through national subscriptions. So again, NList we have provided World e-library near about 6 library and South Asia archives 4.5 million pages. So it's good collection for us. This NList has award by the national and international organization. In 2010, the best choice award goes to the NList. NList best project, the Manthan Award also. The NList Scotch Digital Inclusions Award for the years 2001. So, aise award bhi NList ko mile hai. Kyunki inka jo service hai, provided hai, wo bahut hi अच्छा है मटेरियल अच्छा है इसलिए उनको नेशनल इंटरनेशनल लेवल पे उनको अवार्ड भी मिला है सो नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट हाउ टू जॉइन द एनलिस्ट प्रोग्राम यस व्हेन यू गो ऑन द एनलिस्ट वेबसाइट सो देयर इज द होम पेज इज देयर एंड वन लिंक इज देयर मेंबर So when you click on the members, they have given the information how to join the NList and all details they have given you who is the just say an example eligibility. कौन सा college यहाँ हो सकता है तो all government aided colleges covered under section 12B of UGC Act are eligible to access e-resources through the NList program. And non-aided college except agriculture, engineering, management, medical, pharmacy, dentistry, and nursing can't get benefit for NLIS program. Okay, it means यहाँ non-aided नहीं था, but अभी non-aided को भी यहाँ include कर दिया गया है. ये एक अच्छी बात है, क्योंकि पहले aided college को ही ये NLIS मिलता था, अभी non-aided को भी मिलता है. लेकिन उसका सब्सक्रिप्शन रेट थोड़ा ज्यादा है जैसे यहाँ एनुअल मेंबरशिप उन्होंने दिया है कि रजिस्टर इज कवर्ड अंडर द 12B सेक्शन ऑफ यूजीसी आर रिक्वायर्ड टू पे द ओनली 5,900 देखिए फ्रेंड्स ये 5,900 5,000 मेंबरशिप एंड 900 इट्स अ जीएसटी टैक्स एक्स्ट्रा एज अ एनुअल मेंबरशिप तो 5,900 में अपने को इतना जो मैंने पहले स्टैटिस्टिक बताया इतना सारा अपने को ई रिसोर्सेस मिलता है एक एक प्रिंट का भी जर्नल्स अपन ने सब्सक्रिप्शन करते हैं तो वो 1,00,000 का होता है जैसे स्प्रिंजर का करते हैं सेज का करते हैं टेलर एंड फ्रांसिस का करते हैं तो नियर अबाउट 1,00,000 फॉर द 1 टाइटल बट यहाँ तो उन्होंने इतना दिया है कि अपन बहुत सारे सर्विसेस अपन दे सकते हैं And non-aided college registers on the NLIST program are required to pay 35,400. So non-aided है उनके लिए 35 थोड़ी ज़्यादा दिया है, but 35 में भी आपको इतना सारा मिल सकता है. ये it's a lucky, it's a good things for the non-aided college also. क्योंकि अपन सब्सक्रिप्शन ई बुक्स और ई जर्नल्स जो है उनका सब्सक्रिप्शन रेट देखेंगे तो अपन एक भी टाइटल नहीं कर सकते, लेकिन 35,000 में आपको बहुत सारा मटेरियल मिल सकता है और ऑथेंटिक स्कूल और एकेडमिशन। सो ऑनलाइन रजिस्टर, तो मेंबरशिप में आपको पता चल गया है कि कैसा कैसा कौन कौन एलिजिबल है कौन नहीं है, सो दैट टाइम यू हैव डिसाइडेड कि अवर कॉलेजेस रजिस्टर कर सकते हैं नहीं कर सकते हैं, एंड देन यू गो ऑन द रजिस्टर। ओके, ये रजिस्टर पे क्लिक करेंगे तो ये रजिस्टर का एक पेज ओपन हो जाएगा, एंड आफ्टर दैट यहाँ एक ऐसा एक फॉर्म आता है, you can fill up this online also. So name of the college, all the details of the your colleges you have to mention here. Okay, so which type of course offered by your colleges, so you have to click here simultaneously, and postgraduate hai aapke yahan to postgraduate ka bhi aapko yahan kar sakte hain, the enrollment kitne hai, subject kitne hai, so you can fill up according to your college discipline and college subject and college arts courses. Okay, and after that you have to submit your registration form, and after that you get the all the details authorized from the enlist college administrator. Okay, so enlist brochures, enlist resolution, and other than authorization letter for the enlist college administrators. So administrator to just na college librarian hote hai, because unko jo service dena padta hai to unko hi karna padta hai. So college status जो अपन इंडिया के देखेंगे तो अपने को पता चलेगा कि total colleges 3,472 है, 12B के इतने हैं and non-aided इतने हैं, तो इसके कौन से है तो अपने को पता चलेगा कॉलेज स्टेटस एंड लिस्ट का जो आता है वो यू कैन सी, जैसे डॉक्टर बाबा साहब आम्बेडकर कॉलेज दीक्षा भूमि का देखना है तो डॉक्टर ऊपर आप क्लिक करेंगे तो उनका आ जाएगा, तो ऐसा पूरा आ जाता है। और हर यूनिवर्सिटी हर कॉलेज का एक बिब्लियोग्राफिकल डिस्क्रिप्शन आता है कि वो कॉलेज कौन से यूनिवर्सिटी से रिलेटेड है, एक्टिव है, रिनोवेट ये है या नहीं है, ऑल डिटेल्स आर गिवन बाय दिस। और यहाँ एक साइट वाइज मेंबरशिप कॉलेज का एक आपको देखना है तो यहाँ भी एक उन्होंने दिया है लिंक और वो देख सकते हैं। I have given some chart here, state wise college status. तो आज का स्टेटस क्या है, तो आंध्र प्रदेश से लेके वेस्ट बंगाल तक के पूरा स्टेटस यहाँ दिया है कि कौन से कॉलेज में कौन से स्टेट में कितने कॉलेज अभी तक के ये हुए हैं। तो ये पाई चार्ट में भी मैंने दिखा है कि स्टेट वाइज अगर आप देखते हैं तो महाराष्ट्र इज द हाईएस्ट नंबर ऑफ कॉलेजेस फ्रॉम महाराष्ट्र, दे हैव रजिस्टर एंड टेक द बेनिफिट ऑफ तो नियर अबाउट 798 कॉलेजेस हैं। और आप देखते हैं जो बड़े बड़े जितने भी स्टेट है उनमें से सबसे ज्यादा महाराष्ट्र में ही है, so it is a good news for Maharashtrian. Now search colleges, so search college you have to search here, already I have told to you, you put your college name here and search your colleges, and those who are registered they getting the uses statistic for the each colleges. Okay, so and they can publish the uses to the on the faculties. So how to access e-resources available under the enlist program. So a basic thing is that the internet enabled PCs, laptop for faculty and students, access to internet, also mobile browsers. So it is simply requirement, there is no need to hire contractors So member login. So all the details are there given, and member login. So read more, joining and logging. Member login here. You have to click here all the details and open the member login. Yes. And when you click there, so some you have to. Put your all the information here, and then login to log here and active users also. Okay, so it's a very simple active of the new users. Have given the how to active the new users. There are some instructions given here. PDR enrollment members. You can read the all the details here. I will not.
Hi, Sandram.
Yeah. So new password they have given to you. And after that, you can use your e-resources to the list. So after successfully logging, you can use this. After successfully logging, when they have given the passwords, and, after that, you can use the e-resources. I have given an example here. I have put the one chemistry subject here and click here. After that, they have given the so many titles from the related. Okay. And also, they have given the abstract also. So not only chemistry, so many chemistry are there. So minor subject are under the chemistry. So physical chemistry ke kitne hain, material science ke kitne hain. Ye pura analytical science ke iska pura ye apne ko micro subject ka bhi wo dete hain. And suppose aapko you have to only for you have related research only for the analytical chemistry. That time you have to click only there. So they will give the list. Okay. Yeah. So separate e-journals and e-books also. So e-journals full text ka yahan वैसे मैंने पहले ही chart बता दिया था. And e-book ka bhi aata hai. So आपको वहां से क्लिक कर सकते हैं जैसे आप यू आर रिलेटेड टू द कैम्ब्रिज बुक ऑनलाइन सो यू हैव टू क्लिक हियर एंड दैट टाइटल विल बी ओपन ओके या इनफिनिट लॉगिन सो दिस इज आल्सो द इनफिनिट लॉगिन इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड सर्विस इज प्रोवाइडेड बाय इट्स गुड सर्विसेज. So all the librarians are requested to just logging with the Infinite because remote services they have given e-resources through the Infinite login. Yeah. So I have given the all the means how to search and suppose we have to search by the publishing wise. Example for AIP publishers. So about the publishing they have given and what type of materials these publishers provided to us. So all details they have given here. And according to that publisher wise, if you are the interested in the journals, so you click all the particular titles and access the. I have given the title and search and okay. Advanced search is also there. Simple search is there and advanced search is also there. So save the time of research. Researcher अपन बोलते हैं. So that time advanced search is very important. तो लाइब्रेरी में ये भी सीख लेना चाहिए और अपने जो स्टूडेंट्स है या फैकल्टीज है उनको या एडवांस सर्च के बारे में बताना चाहिए ताकि वो उनका कम से कम टाइम में ज्यादा से ज्यादा रिसोर्सेज उनको अवेलेबल हो सकते हैं. तो सर एक एडवांस सर्च इज देयर लाइक दैट बुलियन सर्च terms together है. So ये bullying search कैसा कर दिया ही है. I will not go because know about the bullying search and others advanced search. Okay. Proximity search के बारे में दिया है and other search के बारे में दिया है. So I have given annual review का एक example मैंने यहाँ quote किया है एक one PPT and content with our experts. Okay, So economics and politics. So this is the good title related to the economic and political weekly. इसका subscription अभी अपन ने जो print version का करते हैं तो अपने को individually near about the 3,500 का अकेले का मिलता है और वो भी only for the 1 year subscription. But यहाँ अगर आप through the endless जाते हैं तो यहाँ का back to value मिलता है but अपने को ये 5,900 में ही बाकी जो साइंस के है टाइटल उसके साथ साथ इकोनॉमिक्स एंड पॉलिटिकल भी मिलता है एंड दिस इज द वेरी गुड फॉर अस या indianjournals.com का भी थ्रू द इंग्लिश मिलता है और यहाँ नियर अबाउट 180 टाइटल्स रिलेटेड टू ऑल द सब्जेक्ट दे हैव अवेलेबल इन द indianjournals.com and this facility provided through the enlist also. So alphabetically you can choose the title and take the all resources or article from that journals. Yeah, JS Store is a very good databases. It's a इसका थोड़ा वर्जन अपने को मिलता है इंग्लिश से बट अच्छा वर्जन जो मिलता है वो शोध सिंधु से क्योंकि यूनिवर्सिटी में ज्यादा रिसर्च ज्यादा होता है तो उनको ये JSTOR बहुत अच्छा काम मिलता है और जैसे लोग बोलते हैं कि ये तो साइंस का ही है इंग्लिश में ही है हमारे लिए कोई है ही नहीं दो जो आर द पीपल फ्रॉम द आर्ट्स एंड ह्यूमैनिटीज एंड सोशल साइंसेस वो बहुत बार बोलते हैं कि इंग्लिश में जो मिलता है वो साइंस ज्यादा मिलता है लेकिन फ्रेंड्स ये JSTOR भी मिलता है ये JSTOR जो है सोशल साइंस के बहुत सारे एंड आर्ट एंड ह्यूमैनिटीज के बहुत सारे टाइटल्स यहाँ से मिल सकते हैं तो आप लाइब्रेरियन एज करके आप इनका जो JSTOR का जो डाटाबेस है इसको आप थरोली आप पूरा देख लीजिए कि इसमें क्या क्या है क्या नहीं है क्या कौन सा आर्काइव्स है कौन से टाइटल्स है एंड देन यू डू टू सर्विस टू यूर आर्ट एंड ह्यूमैनिटीज एंड सोशल साइंस फैकल्टीज एंड स्टूडेंट ऑल्सो या ऑक्सफोर्ड जर्नल्स है ये तो अच्छा ही है मीन्स इनके ऑक्सफोर्ड एकेडमी के जर्नल्स इतने स्टैंडर्ड है कि अपने को वो दोज़ आर द बेसिकली साइंस बैकग्राउंड उनको पता है कि इनके कितने जर्नल्स इंपैक्ट फैक्टरफुल है जर्नल्स बुक्स एंड डेटाबेसेस वो भी हैं इबेस्को का भी उन्होंने दिया है इबेस्को डेटाबेसेस अगर अपन सेपरेटली सपोज सब्सक्राइब करते हैं तो उसके लिए अलग से यूनिवर्सिटी इंफोनेट सिंधु एंड आल्सो द स्मॉल ग्रुप्स आर इंक्लूडिंग थ्रू द इनलिस्ट आल्सो तो ये भी अच्छा एक अपने को मिला है बुक सेंट्रल प्रोक्विस्ट का बुक सेंट्रल जो है यहाँ भी बहुत सारे किताबें जो है वो यहाँ देखने को मिलते हैं यूज करने को प्रोक्विस्ट बुक सेंट्रल कैसे अपने को करना है रीड द ई बुक्स वो दिया है न्यूक्लियर साइंस एक तो एग्जांपल करके दिया है कि न्यूक्लियर साइंस वो बहुत सारे अच्छे जो किताबें हैं अगर अपन ने सब्सक्राइब किया या ई बुक्स बाय करना चाहता तो अपने को नियर अबाउट 50,000 1 लाख का वो एक वन टाइटल अपने को देना पड़ता है सॉरी या वन एग्जांपल आई हैव गिवन फ्रॉम दिस माय स्लाइड्स सेज नॉलेज का तो आपको पता है कि कितने अच्छे सारे टाइटल्स उनके होते हैं टेलर एंड फ्रांसिस ग्रुप के होते हैं साउथ एशिया ई बुक्स लाइब्रेरी सर्चिंग ई रिसोर्सेज का जो इंग्लिश का दिया है ई बुक्स एंड रिसोर्सेज वो उनके साइट पे जाते हैं देखिए यहाँ होम से लेके ऑल द दिया है मींस ऑल लिंक्स दिया है तो आप उस हिसाब से वैसे वैसे अपन कर सकते हैं डाउनलोड भी कर सकते हैं अगर आप डाउनलोड करना चाहते हैं तो डाउनलोड की फैसिलिटी भी है और अलग से आपका ई लाइब्रेरी भी आप बना सकते हैं और ऑफलाइन में आप वो प्रोवाइड कर सकते हैं तो ये भी फैसिलिटी है इंग्लिश की ये तो है कि जितना कवर करना है वो तो मैंने कर लिया है, बट फ्रेंड्स ये जो एनलिस के आप जाओगे वो पेज पे, तो उन्होंने एक लास्ट में उन्होंने दिया FAQ, तो फ्रीक्वेंटली आस्क क्वेश्चन, तो व्हाट इज द एनलिस से लेके वी विल गेट द बेनिफिट वहां तक के सब उन्होंने दिया है, तो आप वो भी पढ़ने के बाद अपना ये कर सकते हैं मैक्सिमम बेनिफिट फ्रॉम द रिसोर्सेस मैंने थोड़ा सा दिया है। अगेन दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट यूजिंग माय अकाउंट, सो कौन से टाइप्स आप कर सकते हैं, सर्च हिस्ट्री है, साइटेशन, एक्सपर्ट साइटेशन, मेल अलर्ट है, आरएस फीड्स, ये भी दिया है उन्होंने, टाइप ऑफ ई अलर्ट्स में कौन सा है, तो टेबल टेबल ऑफ कंटेंट है, न्यू इशू अलर्ट्स है, पब्लिकेशन अलर्ट्स है, ई बुक सर्विस अलर्ट्स है, सो ऑल दिस सर्विसेस यू हैव गिवन मोबाइल सर्विसेस, ईमेल सर्विसेस आल्सो, सो ए भी बेनिफिट्स अपने को यहाँ है। सब द ईमेल कैसा दे सकते हैं इसका भी एक उन्होंने दे दिया है, तो एंटीटू लॉगिंग होता है, तो जो भी कॉलेजेस सब लॉगिंग होता है, लाइब्रेरी इज द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव लॉगर एंड उसको बाकी वो क्रिएट करना पड़ता है स्टूडेंट और यूजर्स का, तो ये परफॉर्म इनवॉइस रिसीव भी मिल से आपने सब्सक्रिप्शन मिल जाएगा, तो ये दिस द डैशबोर्ड, ऐसा डैशबोर्ड आता है बाद में जो होते हैं रजिस्टर सब्सक्राइबर उनका एक डैशबोर्ड आता है, डैशबोर्ड पे पूरा डिटेल्स होता है, यूजर्स डिटेल, अपलोड द बल्क यूजर्स, एक्टिविटी बल्क यूजर्स, सब ये जो डैशबोर्ड पे जितने भी लिंक है वो जो एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव लॉगर होता है उनको मिलता है, एंड यूजर्स डॉक्टर कॉलेज का यूजर्स डिटेल्स देना है, तो यहाँ से आप देख सकते हैं, मिल सकते हैं, एंड यूजर्स भी अपन कर सकते हैं। ओके, तो यहाँ एग्जाम्पल दिया है, अपन अपने अपने कॉलेज से अपन कर सकते हैं, पब्लिशर का ही कितना हो गया वो भी अपने को मिल सकता है स्टैटिस्टिक, और कुछ क्वेरीज रहा तो उन्होंने कांटेक्ट अस करके एक दिया है, और किसको मेल लिखना है वो भी उन्होंने दिया है, तो अगर साइमल्टेनियसली रजिस्टर होने के पहले भी आप उनसे मिल सकते हैं, रजिस्टर होने के बाद भी जैसे अपन सेवाएं देते हैं, तो बहुत सारी तकनीकी या फिर रिसोर्सेस के बारे में अपने को क्वेरीज आती है, तो आपको किसको कॉन्टेक्ट करना है तो उन्होंने दिया है, फोन नंबर भी दिया, ईमेल भी दिया, तो यू कैन कॉन्टेक्ट विद देम ऑल्सो। ओके, तो कॉस्ट बेनिफिट्स ऑफ द एनलिस का प्रोग्राम का जो है उन्होंने दिया है, तो ये या मैंने वेज लिया है इसके, इसमें से उन्होंने जो 19 to 20 एक वन ईयर का दिया है, तो ये अगर आप देखेंगे तो ऐसा पता चलता है कि कितना सारा कॉस्ट वाइज अपने को बेनिफिट मिलता है कम पैसे में, जैसे 5900 रुपीज में कितने सारे पब्लिशर्स का अपने को मिल गया है, और उन्होंने वो भी दिया है कि कितना ये मिला है बेनिफिट मिला है, यूजर्स मिला है, देखिए बुक्स का भी उन्होंने दिया है, उससे पता चलता है कि क्या कैसे यूजेस हो रहा है, मंथ वाइज यूनिक विजिटर्स ऑफ द एनलिस प्रोग्राम, मंथ वाइज प्रोग्रेस व्यूज जो भी है वो सबका उन्होंने जितना भी रिसोर्सेस दिया है, कॉस्ट रिकवरी फैक्टर्स ही जनरल सब्सक्रिप्शन अंडर द एनलिस प्रोग्राम वो भी दिया है, एक चार्ट भी उन्होंने दिया है, ये सब आप देखेंगे उनके उनके वेबसाइट पे है ये सब पूरा स्ट्रेटेजी, तो ये देखने के बाद अपने को पता चलता है कि इतने सारे महंगे महंगे ई रिसोर्सेस ओनली 1 year में जो सब्सक्राइब करते हैं, इट इज द सब्सक्राइब बेस इन दिस प्रोग्राम, 5900 में अपने को मिलता है. सो इट्स अ गुड बेनिफिट फॉर अस. So all the librarians, we have to take the initiatives for the subscriptions and request to your higher authority like that principals and other higher authorities. It's very essential for the our faculties and users and NAC purpose also. Okay. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much. And lastly, thanks to all the organizers and from the college. Principal madam and Rajesh Lokhande sir, we are given the opportunity for the express my views to the on the topic in this program. Thank you very much.
Sir, thank you very much, sir.
If you have any questions, they can ask you from the college. Principal madam and Rajesh Lokhande sir, we are given the
thank you sir
express my views to the on topic is thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. Your session was full of priceless knowledge. You shared tremendous knowledge about
English. So they can ask you,
sir. Any problem? So Bahadur sir,
yeah, it's well going. Please
continue. Shall I continue?
Sure.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir. Yeah. So you share tremendous knowledge about it to us. Thank you very much, sir. I am also grateful to our respected principal, Dr. Mrs. Bhumi Mehre, for her words of encouragement. Her able guidance has always encouraged us. I am really thankful to her for her kindness, her interest, her hospitality, and her continued support. I am really thankful to Mr. Rajesh Lokhande, librarian of Dr. Ambedkar College, Dikshabhumi, Nagpur, for organizing such a wonderful program. Thank you so much. Now I request Dr. Pratima Lokhande to please continue. Thank you.
Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Good Welcome, afternoon, ma'am.
Ladies and gentlemen, I, Dr. Pratima Lokhande, take this virtual.
Yes, madam. Yes, ma'am.
I, Dr. Pratima Lokhande, take this virtual platform today to extend my warm welcome to all the distinguished guests, the sole person, and all the participants to this second technical session. Again, it is a great pleasure for me to introduce our speaker today, Dr. Shalini Lihitkar, madam. She is associate professor in Department of Library Science of Rashtrasant Tukoloji Maharaj Nagpur University, Nagpur. Madam has been a librarian in this library profession since 2002, and she has also won the gold medal from Nagpur University. She worked as a head of the Department of Library Science, Rashtrasant Tukoloji Maharaj, Nagpur University, Nagpur, from 2009 to 2014, and professor and head Department of Library Science, Shivaji University, Kolhapur. She has experience of teaching and guiding for UGC, NEET, and other competitive examinations too. She has a vast 17 years teaching experience in library science field. She has published several papers in seminars, conferences, journals at national and international level, and has more than 180 papers to her credit. She has edited 17 conferences and workshop proceedings and compiled course materials of workshops and refresher courses in library science. She is the author of 9 books. She has completed information literary project with UNESCO and SALIS as a member. She has completed UGC minor research project and ICSSR research project, and she is currently working on ICMR extramural. She was a columnist in Mahiti Yug and editorial board member in Information Age Quarterly Journal. She has organized various workshops, two national conferences, and coordinated 4 UGC refresher courses in library and information science. She is also an editorial member of Journal of Advancement in Library Science, Rashtriya Sant Tukaroji Maharaj and Nagpur University Research Journal of Humanities, and guest editor for special issue on open resource software of DJLIT. She is an expert member in the definitional glossary of Library Science Project of Ministry of Scientific and Technical Terminology, Government of India. She is also a content writer for EPG Parshala, InfliBNet at Ahmedabad and ICAR. She has been a person in various orientation and refresher courses at various universities. She is also a research supervisor at the Rashtriya Sant Tukaroji Maharaj Sant Gadge Amravati University, Amravati. She has extended her guidance to various students, and 8 students have been awarded PhD under her. She is having different portfolios in professional and academic bodies on various universities. She has presented at international conferences to name at Malaysia, Muscat, Hong Kong, Russia, and Sri Lanka. Recently, it is worth mentioning, she has been honored with Young LIS Professional Award by Karnataka State SC and ST Library Professionals Association. And she has also received Best Paper Award sponsored by Korea Institute of Science and Technology Information, South Korea. She is a life member of various professional associations too. Madam, I am really honored to introduce you. And in the age of internet and web, which is constantly influencing the development of new modes of scholarly communication, whereby there are radical changes in information, how it is to be gathered, stored, and accessed, your topic, that is e-resources, is very, very important in this context. So Madam is today going to talk on e-resources, and I'm humbly request you, Madam, to deliver your address. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Thank you, Dr. Pratibha Madam. Just I want to confirm with the organizer, my voice is, I am audible?
Yes, you are audible, ma'am.
Okay. Previously, I had a technical problem of microphone. So I have connected with my mobile. And for screen sharing, I am connected with this PC. My screen is visible, madam?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah.
Thank you, Dr. Pratibha Madam. Just I want to confirm with the organizer, my voice is audible. Okay. Previously, I had a technical problem of microphone, so I have connected with my mobile. And for screen sharing, I am connected with this PC. My screen is visible, madam. Okay, I'm starting my presentation. So before I would like to start my presentation, I am very much thankful to Dr. Respected Principal Madam, Dr. Mehre Madam, and all the college authority and the faculty members. And I can also find out Dr. Rabadi Sir, Dr. Pandey Sir, and the other dignitaries, convener of this national webinar, Rajesh Lokhande and Dr. Bahadure sir and other faculty members. So good afternoon, all dear participants. Let us talk about just Dr. Anil Chikate sir has given a very wonderful presentation on NLIST, and let us talk about how we can use this open educational resources for our teaching, research and learning purpose. So this is now a digital era, and we have to create our digital footprints. And for this, we have to also create our digital and other faculty. And for this academic environment,
we have to show our
research, particularly the publications and all this, and how we can avoid, means how we can also raise our research visibility. And for this, it is very necessary for the research scholar or even the faculty members and the other LIS professionals to create their IDs so that they can show their research visibility and they can showcase their publications. So for this, all such type of research IDs, we have to create it. And this presentation basically endeavors to throw a light on various aspects, that is, what is open access and open educational resources, and how we can search for the journals, how we can search for the thesis, how we can search for the IR, that is institutional repository. And there are many online learning platforms, how we can search it, and some of the useful resources also we can search, and how all these useful resources like open educational resources, we can use it for our teaching and learning purpose. So let us talk about what is open educational resources. As many of you know that advancement in science and technology has made a tremendous impact on every field, and libraries are no exceptions to this. Previously, we are handling the traditional library, we are doing the management of traditional library, but we have to shift to the digital library, and the outcome of this digital library, we have to provide the e-resources access to all our users. So all what is mean by e-resources, it is a books or any type of e-journals, online journals, offline journals, and which is now a very we have to provide to the users, and that is the order of the day. But what happened? NLIST is okay, Shodhasindhu is okay, but if the library is facing some financial crunch, so for that these open educational resources, they have a potential for the academic institutions. So every faculty members and research scholar, they should know what is this open educational resources. So when we talk about the searching on the web, so generally when we search in the Google or any Wikipedias or any search engines, so that time whenever we do the search, that time only 4% results we are getting. So Google is providing n number of results, but still we can find out that only 4% information is with us. But if we know about directly the sites, like that is called as a deep web, so they are providing you 90% of the results. So in comparison with this all search engines. So like academic information is also available on deep web, legal documents, scientific reports. So everything which is academically information, they are available in the deep web, and we should not bother about the dark web. That is a illegal information. We don't want to take it, but we should also concentrate on the deep web, so that whatever general results we are searching on the very by using the search engine, we have to concentrate on the deep web. And that's why this presentation will be useful for the faculty members and the LIS professional, as well as we all know that various type of information resources are there. This is only the primary information, as all the faculty members might be knowing. All the resources are divided into three parts, that is primary resources, secondary resources, and tertiary resources. So primary resources includes the periodicals, research monographs, research reports, patent is also coming under the primary information, then standards, even we search the information from the trade literature also, dissertation, it is also good information source. Primary source and thesis also. So these are coming under the primary sources of information. And when we talk about the secondary sources, we shows the location of the primary sources, that is called indexes is included in the secondary resources, bibliography, even indexing periodicals, abstracting periodicals, review, treatises, then textbooks and reference books are coming under the secondary resources. And we all know that tertiary resources are also there, which indicates the secondary resources and the primary resources, that is bibliography of bibliographies, directories, and guide to literature are also coming. So how this traditional information resources are converted into the various type of e-resources. So whatever traditional resources we are using, then if it is available in the electronic form, then it is called as a e-resources. That is the simple meaning of the e-resources. Then let us talk about what is open access. Open access resources is a digital, online, free of cost and free of most of the copyright and licensing restriction. So only the thing is we have to attribute it. So open access resources are available on the internet for downloading, for using. And it is a free of cost, but only the thing is we should also give the proper attribution, whatever resources we are using. So here the RMT, that is reference management tools, are very, very important for providing the citation, proper citation or proper attribution to the whatever resources we are using. So if we use these open access resources, as we all know that it is a freely available and free of cost, and user can read it many times, we can download it, we can copy it, we can distribute it, or even we can share it, and we can crawl them for the indexing purpose in our library webpage and other lawful purpose also. Only the thing is, we have to give a proper attribution of the authorship. Then how we can use all these open educational resources? As an educator, you can use it. As a student also, for learning purpose, you can use it. And as a self-learner, because as we all know, learning is a continuous process, and we have to learn without any restrictions, without any age bar, and without any particular thing. So for that, self-learner is very important. So how we can use all, and we can reuse it for our teaching purpose, for our research purpose, and for our learning purpose. And many of the resources during COVID-19, many of the publishers, they are providing the free access to the content. Even you can find out that previously in last, like Isho Sindhu, it was, or even in the National Digital Library of India, many of the highly reputed publishers, they have come up with the content access freely, and they have given the access to all such type of resources, because everybody was sitting at the home, and our research should not be disturbed. And that's why during COVID-19, many of the publishers, they have given the access to the e-resources free of cost. And if we use all these open access resources, it will also support our research, it will support also our teaching and learning process, and it is the we free of plagiarism, so we can use it. And once you publish the material with the open access platform, then there is a chances of getting the higher citations, and it is because it is accessible to all. If you have a subscription of Isho Sindhu or even the NLIST, the restricted members only can see your paper. Or even if you have access of Web of Science and the Scopus and the elsewhere databases, then those who are subscribing it, they only take the advantage of your publication. But if it is in the open access platform, then everybody can see it, and your citation index will be also increased. So your impact of your authorship, impact of your article will be more, and definitely the journal impact will be also more. So once you can, I have sum up here that open educational resources, which are, it is not all open educational resources, because it is an ocean of resources. It is like an ocean, and there we can have some various type of resources. But for searching purpose, you can see that for searching the journals, you can use this PLS, even Directory of Open Access Journals. If you want to search the open courseware, like e-learning material or e-content, you can use this Swayam Prabha. MIT courseware is also there, which is the first courseware at the world level or international level. You can also use the CEC consortia. We can also go into the depth of all these type of resources. You can use this IR, and which can be used, accessed through the Directory of Open Access Repository. ROAR is also there, ROAD is also there. And if you want to search for the books, you can use this Universal Digital Library Project, or even DOIBA is also there, and National Digital Library of India is also there. So if you want to search the thesis, you can use this Vidyanidhi, NDLTD, Shodh Gangotri, and Shodh Ganga. So let us talk about, in short, about all such type of e-resources. So DOEJ, Directory of Open Access Journal, which is launched in 2003 at Lund University, and they are providing you the very free article level search they are providing you. You can see here that 14,757 journals are available, and near about 49,69,824 articles are which you can accessible freely. So you can see that how much information is available for our subject. So it will cover all science, technology, medicine, and social sciences, and humanities is also there. And you can see that it is a one-stop shop for the users, those who want to search for the open access journals. So here, this is the homepage of DOAJ. You can search or browse by subject also. You can search facilities also there. You can see it. And if you browse by the subject, you can subject-wise, you can browse it. So it is up to you which subject you want. So just I have searched for the life sciences. And here you can see that 4,43,510 records you will find in a single click. So we have to learn how to click to learn and learn to click. So both is very important. How to click and click to learn. So if you know the single click of the particular or very worthy resources, then you can easily access the information, and that is the beauty of the e-resources which are available on the internet. You can see here that I have taken the example of like you can see that for medicine, how many journals are available for biology, science, or even for other subjects also, they are providing you the result. So you can also see that. The next resource is for Google Scholar. Even Google Scholar is also providing some scholarly material. You can see that. And scholarly literature is also available. You can also explore the related works through one single click. And you can also locate your document through library facility. They are providing you, and that is a very good facility. If you are doing a research on particular topic, and if you register for the Google Scholar account or even the Google Scholar profile, if you have, then you can set the alerts for your recent publication. So whenever you get any publication related with your subject, then they will send you the alerts. Yes, this article is published and you can have some access. Then you can also create an author public profile, and they are also providing you the ready-made journal metrics. So if you want to publish any article with the highly impacted journals, UGC Care List is also there. Yes, that is a one good source, but you can also trust the Google Scholar journal metrics. And there is a very good facility, friends. You can see that library support and library link and search facility is also there. So if you want to save any records, like in the next slide, I have that page. So if you want to save your records in the Google Scholar library, you can set your library, and then you can see that how you can locate the information. See here that I have given the keywords like biodiversity for sustainable development. So here you can create the my profile option is there and my library option is there. So once you want to save this record, then for example, I want to just save my first record, first result that is on intellectual property. So if you just click on the star button, then you will you are saving that article on your My Library. And if you click on this double inverted commas, then you can see that this can be various reference management tool they are providing, and you can use it. Then cited by. So this cited by is showing that this particular article is cited by this one. It means like 72 authors, other authors or research scholar, and that will be a very good article. So based on these statistics also, you can decide that, yes, this article is useful for giving the citation or using the particular material, and you can just evaluate that how this article is very useful. And if you click on the related article, then based on this topic, you will also get the related article. You can customize your search also with the help of this year-wise range they are also providing. If you want to search patent or if you want to include in your citation, you can see it. And create alert is also there. So friends, here Google Scholar is very good source of information also, and it is a very good source for managing your profile for regarding the matric studies and the H index and the various indexes they are providing. And My Library is a very good facility for the research scholar, those who are doing a particular research in depth for your subject. So for that, you can set your My Library alert. That is a good facility. You can see here that just I have saved some of the records, those which are the interest area of mine, like open source software than science mapping tool. Searching on your library, you can save it and you can search.
Then why Google Scholar matter?
Maybe knowing that they are providing you the citation metrics like H index and I10 index, and it will be whenever you received any citation for your work, then it will be automatically updated, and it is very fast to set up. And Google Scholar, once you create the Google Scholar profile, the security issue won't come anywhere, because it is not transferable once you set up your email ID and everything. And it is very easy, and it is very updated information, means updation of publication can be very easy. And you can discover your profile with at the international level. And it is a very good measure. It is a gateway for showcasing your research. So this is my page of the Google Scholar, where you can see that whatever articles I am taking my example, so don't take it otherwise, because I don't have any options to access the other scholars profile. So I'm taking all my examples here. So if we publish a paper and if we set for the Google profile, then it will showing the citation. And nowadays for any funding agencies, they will ask you, everything is depend on the research and what will be the impact of your research as an individual or as an institutional level, what will be the impact. So for that, they will ask you about the H10 index and the I10 index. So Google Scholar, if you set your profile, then automatically you get the H10 index and I10 index, and what will be your citation, what will be the impact of your articles on the others. So that can be also called as a citation metric. So for this, you can use this Google Scholar. I think many of the participants, you are using it. But if you are not using it, then you can just start using the Google Scholar. And as the discussed by Dr. Chikate, that eShodh Sindhu is there. And now the NList is also merged in the eShodh Sindhu. But individual subscriptions can be also there. But 1,000, near about 10,000 e-journals are available. 3,13,500, I mean 5,000 e-books are also available. They are providing you the 22 e-resources and 4 databases are also there. And which is a subscribed one. It is not coming under the open access platform. You have to subscribe it. But other resources are also there. If you want to search for the thesis, you can use this Shodh Ganga. As we all know, this is an initiative of the InfibNet Ahmedabad. And according to the UGC regulation, which came into exist for the MPhil and PhD, you have to submit your PhD, means you have to submit the soft copy of your PhD thesis, and after awarding, then it will be uploaded to the Shodh Ganga. So they are providing you the thesis now. Till now, 2,71,000, more than 71,000 theses are uploaded. You can use it. This is the particular homepage of Shodh Ganga, inflibnet.ac. You have to go for that. And you can see here that how many theses are uploaded. Month-wise statistics also they are providing you. If you want to search various languages like Bengali, Malayalam, Arabic, you can search it for any thesis. You can see here that the subject-wise search is also available, like chemistry, how many journal means how many theses are available for biology, how many theses, then life sciences. So you can search according to your subject, choice of your subject. And you can see that it can be also available free, means it can be also available in the full text form. So the results are here. If you just click on the first result, then you can see that all chapters will be here. Based on this link, you can go for the particular chapter wise also. They you can have the access, like this is the first chapter just I'm opening, and you can use it. So that is one Shodh Gangotri. Shodh Ganga is a good source of searching the thesis. And Shodh Gangotri, as we all know, Shodh Gangotri is a repository of Indian research in progress. And till now, 7,645 Shodh, synopses are also available. And it will be a very good source when we choose a topic or research problem, then you can use it, all such type of resources like Shodh Gangotri, and it will give the what is the trend in that particular subject which is conducted by various universities. So for this, it is a very good source, those who are doing. So on the means progress, research in progress, that particular type of information they are showing here, and all the proposals also shown in the Shodh Ganga site. So Indian research in progress, you can search by the university wise, issue date wise, researcher guide wise, title wise, keyword wise, and university wise also you can search it. So for that, that is a good source for searching the research in progress, Shodh Gangotri. Then next source is University of Mysore. Previously, they are providing only access to the e-thesis, but now they have converted that e-thesis repository to the institutional repository. So every type of source they are also providing. So that is one good source, University of Mysore source, you can use it. And they are also providing all type of resources. It may be a thesis, or it may be a books or e-journals. Then if you want to search at the international level, thesis and dissertation, so you can use this network digital library of thesis and dissertation. It is an international organization which is dedicated for promoting the adoption, creation, and the dissemination and the preservation of especially the electronic thesis and dissertation. You can see here that 59,27,845 theses are also available. And if you take the membership, then you can also submit your thesis at the international level. So that is also one of the source, Network Digital Library of Thesis and Dissertation. And you can use it for biology. Just I have given the word for biology. 778 international theses are also available, which is in the open access platform. So that is one good source for searching the thesis. We have seen that Shodh Ganga, Shodh Gangotri, and NDLTD, and University of Mysore repositories. And if you want to search for the courseware or e-contain, you can use this EPG Parshala. As we all know that it is a government initiative, a Ministry of Human Resource Development under the mission of ICT. They have assigned this job to the UGC, and they have developed, like InfliMNet has also maintaining these 70 subjects at post-graduation level. And high quality curriculum based interactive contents are also available in this. And you can see here that many e-text videos, expert, or even quiz. So if you want to solve any quiz, you can use this EPG Parshala, or even for the teachers, if you want to set the papers, you can use this EPG Parshala, and they are providing a very good content based on the curriculum based, they are providing the content. You can see here that how many subjects are available. All the modules are also available in the e-text form and video form also it is available. You can see that for library science, 395 modules are also available, and you can use it for management, 599 modules are also available. But due to time paucity, I'm not going into the depth of all the subject. So if you want to just search for the paper, then you can search it, ecosystem concept, structure and function. So just click on the paper and module. So in that particular paper, there are many modules, and then you can have the e-text search. In the Learn More facility, they have given the link Learn More. So there are very good sources also they have given. And if you want to click on the video, you can just click on the self-learning. So video will be also open. So this is just example I have taken for mine. And you can see that video is also available in the EPG Parshala. And they are providing their, means apart from EPG Parshala, vertically they are providing very good sources like e-Adhyan. For ebooks access, they are providing. And UGC MOOC, it is a vertical of SWAM. We can also go into the depth. E-Pathyay is also there. It is also a vertical of EPG Parshala, which is a software-driven course and which is a content management package that facilitated students pursuing higher education like PhD. All the distance learning courses are also available in the this E-Pathyay. So you can just have the access of ER, then UGC MOOC and the ePATTA for your search. Then SWAM, it is a program initiated by Government of India, and they are providing the best teaching learning resources to all. And I think during COVID-19, many of the participants, you have taken the advantage of this SWAM courses. Even I have done some courses on this SWAM, and it was a very good experience. We can really learn because the quality of the video is very good and the content wise, it is a very good. So if you want to learn, then you can use this SWAM government initiative. And you can see here that many courses are available for the AICT, even the NPTEL, UGC, CEC, NCERT, or National Institute of Open Schooling courses are also available. And at undergraduate level, some courses. What I'm suggesting here to the library professionals that you have to give the orientation about all the SWAM and Sakshat and the other type of online platform to our students, so that if they won't come to the physically for attending the classes, at least they can have some access and they can learn it. Self-learning is very important. So for that, you can orient your users about the SWAM courses. And means we don't know what will be the future of education, because COVID-19 has given us a very good experience. Previously, we won't go for online courses and the online teaching also, or online delivering of our lectures. But nowadays, we have to go online. There is no option. So COVID-19 has given us a very good chances also for learning and teaching. So that is there. You can see here that the SWAM, many courses are also available in the SWAM. You can also orient your student. Then SWAM Prabha is there. Through library, we can provide this SWAM Prabha. DTH channel is also there, and which will be live casting, telecast will be there for high quality educational program, and which is available in the 24/7 basis. They are using the satellite, and many courses are very good courses in this. And the contents which are provided by the NPTEL, even the IIT, UGC, CEC, or IGNU, or NCERT, they are providing. And InfliNet is maintained this web platform. So you just go to swamprabha.gov, and there you will see that many channels are also available. They are providing the DTH channel, and which will cover the higher education, school education, even they are covering, and curriculum based courses are also there. And they are also insisting, means assist the student for competitive examination. So that is a very good channel. Even the libraries can take the initiative to have the access of the SWAM Prabha, and some of one room, the library can provide it for SWAM Prabha. For accessing the channels to the student, so that the student will come directly to the library, and everybody is accepting that student won't come to the library. So if we convert into the innovative services by using all these ICT tools, then automatically they will come to the library and they will use the library. So you can see here that when we do the subject-wise search, you can also refine the search. Computer science is there, electric, mechanical engineering, and many English is also available. Hindi courses are also available. Pharmacy courses are also available. So based on your subject, you can choose that SWAM Prabha channel. Even Sakshat is also there. You can see here that for undergraduate courses, postgraduate courses, and other online learning platforms, they are providing. So for that, Sakshat is a very good site. And you can see that from there, whatever government initiatives are there for the open courseware, they are providing the access to that Sakshat website, so that you can use it. Then at international level, if you want to search for the courseware, you can go for the MIT courseware, that is called as a OCW, and they are providing 2,400 courses. And you can see here that once you just do the search, you can find the course. Just I have given the keyword as a life sciences, and in life sciences, many courses are available. If you join the course, you can see here that you can do the subject search and even course content wise also. Like if you want to access the assignment, you can access it. Even audio visual lecture also you can access it. So there are many course content, types of course contents are available. Even you can give the exams, even you can access the lecture notes also. So that is very good features they are providing in this MIT courseware. And there are many other online learning platforms are also available, like eGyankosh, Nishta is there, NROER is also there, CEC. eYantra, if any faculty from the engineering background, you can use this eYantra. Badal is also there for cloud-based services. Spoken Tutorial is also there. Shagun is also there. Fosi is also there. And virtual labs are very available. So during this COVID-19, if the students are not coming to the lab, chemical labs and all these things, then here also virtual labs also there. So that is a very good features they are providing. So in labs, we are mixing the chemicals based on some portion, means based on some percentage. And then what will be the reaction? So we are giving the training physically. But here, by using the virtual lab, same training we can give it. So once you have a time, you can use this virtual lab facility also. And if you want to learn any open source software, you can use this FOSI. FOSI is a very good source for learning any open source software. So you can use it. So this is the eyantra.org for engineering. And they are doing a very innovative programs and for eyantra lab setup initiatives. And they are doing the resource development center also, and many innovative challenges and innovative symposium they are using. For searching the repositories, you can use this high quality global directory that is called as a directory of open access repositories. And it is also maintained by the Lund University and in collaboration with the Nottingham University. And they are providing you the resources like what are the various digital resources which are available in the open DOR, that is Directory of Open Access Repositories. And you can search the repositories. Advanced search option is also there. Browse by country option is also there. You can have it. And they are providing you the content like journal article access, thesis and dissertation access, book chapter, conference proceeding, reports, and many references, means many type of content they are. Even they are providing you the patent type content, or even the software also they are providing, and in their learning object also they are providing. So you can search the OpenDR. And if you look at the subject wise chart, then you can see that many subjects are available even for library science. 144 institutional repositories are also available for biochemistry and biology, 204. According to your subject choice, you can use it. There is another source that is called as a Directory of Open Access Scholarly Resources. It is a service. You can search from the ISSN International Center if you have the ISSN number. And they are also providing you the 1.8 million of bibliographic records and near about 2 lakhs digital titles they are providing. So this is the site of the road. You can search. This is a Directory of Open Access Scholarly Resources. So according to the ISSN number or according to the subject, according to the title, you can search it. And they are providing you the quality, means qualitative open educational resources, even journal, conference proceeding, academic repository, monograph series, or even some scholarly blogs are also can be searchable with this road. And this is a roadmap that is a registry of open access repository mandates and policy. And this is a InfliBNet initiative. It is a subject gateway for Indian electronic resources. And you can also search, browse. Many online catalogs are also available. So whatever resources are available in the Indian platform, like e-resources. So from this site, you can use it, InfoPort. This is a subject gateway for Indian electronic resources. So you can have the search according to subject wise also, or if you know the DDC classification, then according to DDC classification also, you can browse the subject. So whatever InfoPort covers various internet resources which are Indian origin, and many resources you can see here that I have given the list of e-resources which you can search. for searching the books, especially you can use this National Digital Library of India, as we all know that it is the Ministry of Human Resource Project, and it will give you one single platform for searching facilities. And due to paucity of time, I'm going very fast. You can do the bulk registration through library. So faculty members can give the email ID and other type of information to the librarians, and bulk registration can also possible. Individual registration can also possible, and just fill the information and then they will send you the verification list by your mail, and you can use it all such type of resources. So in the National Digital Library of India, you can see here that how many like lectures notes are also available, video class notes, courseware, papers, even for setting our papers for our subject, you can use this National Digital Library of India, because various range of contents they are providing. You can see here in this slide that how many contents they are providing, even the annual reports, project reports, working paper, encyclopedia, directories, data set, manuscripts. So various range of contents are available in the National Digital Library of India. You can see here this figure, I cannot read out also, how many resources are available in this National Digital Library of India. And during this COVID-19 also, they have given the research repository. So whatever the, not only open educational resources or open access resources, but other type of resources which are commercialized, means which are on the subscription based, that is also available in this National Digital Library of India during this COVID-19. They might have now not given the access for the resources, subscribed based resources, but offline means open access resources, they are providing you the access. Only the thing is, if you want to do the bulk registration, then go through the library and register for yourself. And if you don't want to go through library, individually also you can register. And they will say, they will create the password and they will share the link also. And after that, they will provide you the access through National Digital Library of India. And many of the participants, you have already registered it. And some, if some librarians are also there, you can also do some bulk registration of your faculty members or even the research scholar. So there are many links are also available in the National Digital Library of India. You can search by resource type, like books, you can search article, thesis, video lectures, audio lectures, or the manuscripts also you can search. There are many featured resources. You can see here that 6 million, above 6 million records are available. 30 million records are available. So only the thing is, you have to just see that how to click it. So click to learn and learn to click again. I'm just revising that quote also. So if you know one click, good click, then you may be having the access of various type of resources. Even you can search in the National Digital Library of India subject language wise, like Hindi if you want, English if you want, Marathi, Gujarati, Malayalam, and other language which I cannot read also. So you, in that way you can search the language wise search is also there. And if you want to just refine your search, you can see here that many type of links are also available, like access registration, author, subject category, educational degree, difficulty level, educational level. So all type of you can do your search, you can refine your search according to the different type of features which the National Digital Library of India is providing. You can search here that access restriction. So what will be the open access material or subscribe material? You can refine your search. That is a very good facility available in the National Digital Library of India. You can search author-wise also. So many authors, whatever databases they have, so according to that, you can search author-wise. Even a very good facility is that difficulty level. So if you want that food science, I'm taking the example of food science. So food science only for UG level, so you will get the material for UG level. If you want that food science for PG level, then you will get the material. So difficult level, educational level also, you can see from means class 1 to PG, you can see the different type of file formats are also available. Even language search is also available. You can search by the learning resource type also. and subject search is also level. So here it is a very good feature. So the National Digital Library of India is providing that. Even if you search, like for example, I'm searching for the second level, just knowledge or classification, then you can see that the, in the third level, you will go into the depth. So that is the beauty of the National Digital Library of India. If you, so you can go with the level also, first level, second level, and third level. So librarians has to just introduce all such type of resources to their users so that they can refine their search and they can use it. Then the other source is DOAB, that is called as a Directory of Open Access Repositories. And there are many academic peer-reviewed books are also available, and which is published, means which is given by the 386 publishers. And you can have the search in National Directory of Open Access books also. You can see here that agriculture books, biology, chemistry, or even library science books are also available, and history and archaeology and English subject books are also available. And World Digital Library is also, it is a project by UNESCO. You can, once you get the time, then you can also use this World Digital Library. And many of the resources are available in the World Book Digital Library, or even the Universal Digital Library. A million books are available in the Universal Digital Library. And for specifically for science, you can use this free science information. And many other e-resources, which I just told you that this is the ocean of information. And just I have selected some of the resources which are very effective and which are very helpful to the users or even faculty members and research scholar. So there are another, I mean, other useful resources. Just I am list outing that e-Krishi Shiksha, e-Pops, e-Krishi Kosh, Sera is there, Enlist, which Dr. Chikate sir has already covered. BookBub is there, Digital Book Index, Google Book, Project Gutenberg, Library of Congress, it is also a good source. And Honkai, it is also, it is a good source. So there you can use all such type of e-resources. And if you use all such type of resources, and if you publish the material, then you have to take care of the research visibility. And nowadays, every accreditation agencies, they are asking you what will be your impact of your research on the other. So for that, we have to take care about what type of tools we can use it for enhancing our research visibility. So you can use it, the various Allmetric tools like Impact Story, PLS, and many of the PlumX is also there for Allmetric tool. You can use it. You can even you can use it, the academic and social networking sites and various social medias also, you can use it. And you can also deposit your publication with the institutional archives or the institutional repository. And ultimately, you have to use or utilize all features of the open access tools that you have already learned. And you can manage your research profile so that your visibility of your publication should be enhanced. And if it is enhanced, then our institutional visibility will be also enhanced, and it will be impacted on the others. So for this, you can use various tools like Scopus Author ID, Web of Science, Publon, Google Scholar, Orchid ID, LinkedIn, ResearchGate, Academia, and various social networking sites. You can use it. And even some of the reference management tool, they are also providing you the facility for create your profile, like Mendeley and the Zotero. And IR also, you can use it. And if possible, you can have your profile with the Vidwan database, which is initiative of the InfliNet and Allmetric tools, you can use it. So to sum up, open educational resources give faculty the ability to customize course material, creating the perfect course packet for our student. And nowadays, every faculty member has to create all such type of videos and for the teaching purpose. So for this, you can use all such type of e-resources. And nowadays, it is becoming a valuable alternative to improve the access of high quality educational content, and which is released under the open licensing platform by outstanding university worldwide. So you can use all such type of e-resources for your teaching purpose, for your learning purpose. So here you can see that one picture. It doesn't matter how many resources you have, but if you don't have how to use it, then it will be never enough. So you have to use some type of resources. And I can just sum up that according to Samuel Johnson, knowledge is of two kinds. We know a subject ourselves, or as a faculty member, we all know that our subject is strong, but we should also try. We know where to find the information about a subject so that our subject will be also more stronger. So I can sum up with this Samuel Johnson quote. And thank you to the organizers for giving me the opportunity to express my views on this webinar. So thank you once and all. And thank you to the participants for listening patiently. Over to the organizers. Thank you.
As a faculty member, we all know that our subject is this but we should also try. We know where to find the information about the subject so that our subject will be also more stronger. So I can sum up with this Samuel Johnson quote. And thank you to the organizers for giving me the opportunity to express my views on this webinar. Thank you once and all. And thank you to the participants for the invitation. Over to the organizers. Thank you.
If participants may ask questions now.
Madam, we have a question here. Shalini, madam.
Yes, sir. Am I audible?
Yeah, we have a question from a participant. She is asking, is institutional email ID necessary for creating Google Scholar account? So please explain.
Yes, it is necessary, but if you don't have, then you can create with your personal IDs also. But if it is an institutional ID, then all the publications which we have, it will be at the institutional level. Okay, so it will be automatically, if you have an institutional ID, then it is very good. But nowadays, every institution is providing our email ID. Means institution is also providing the facility to create the email ID. So that is very good. And even the institution is not providing, then the institution can take the help of this Google email. They are providing you the facility for the institutions. Like we are creating the Gmail account. So for Gmail for institution, there is an option. So that option, every institution can use it. And nowadays that option is free of cost. The institution can take the advantage. Any IT person can give the responsibility from the college side and you can use it. Or even for the Google Classroom, all features, you can use it for Google for education. So that is very good facility nowadays the Google is providing. And during this COVID-19, Google has given all features free of cost. So at least anybody can take the advantage of this Google.
Email for institution, there is
I think my voice is echoing. Again, it is taking.
Is free of cost. The institution can take the advantage. Any IT person can.
Yes, you can. You can.
Qualified and you can use it. Or even for the Google Classroom, all features.
Lokhande, madam. Please take over.
That is very good facility nowadays the Google is providing. And during this COVID-19, Google has given all features free of cost.
Stop, sir.
Shalini, madam, please stop sharing your screen.
Yes.
I think my voice is echoing. Again, it is taking.
I have stopped, sir. Now it is okay?
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Yes.
Okay.
Thank you very much, madam, for your informative presentation on open resources, that is e-resources. You have rightly highlighted the preferences and importance of various open resources like Google Scholar, My Library, Shodh Gangotri, EPG Pathshala, E-Adhyayan, E-Pathya, and also other resources which we are not aware of, like Directory of Open Access, National Digital Library, and World Digital Library. So on behalf of Knowledge Resource Center Library of DACM, I would like to express my sincere thanks to Lihitkar Madam for the knowledge and guidance she has extended to all of us, which will be helpful in our research process, Madam. And of course, as you said, that we all need to know what to click and click to learn. So we assure you, Madam, that you have shown us various ways that where to click and how to click, and therefore we'll all learn to click and click to learn. Thank you so very much on behalf of Dr. Ambedkar College, Diksha Bhumi Nagpur. Thank you, sir. Over to you, Madhure, sir.
Yeah, thank you very much, Madam. May I now request one of the members of this national webinar, Dr. Ajay Kumar Agashe, to take over the proceedings of the webinar as we are moving towards the valedictory function of the national webinar on e-resources for academic excellence by Dr. Ambedkar College, Diksha Bhumi Nagpur. Agashe, sir.
Thank you, Shailesh, sir. Thank you very much. So, good afternoon, everyone. Honorable management of Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar College, Diksha Bhumi Nagpur, respected Dr. B. M. Mehre, ma'am, principal of the college, all the resource persons of today's wonderful webinar, organizing team members, and my dear virtual friends. Really, today's webinar was wonderful. All the resource persons and talks are very nice. Now, we are moving towards the valedictory function. So for this wonderful webinar, we have as a chief guest, Dr. Lagdir Rabari, Deputy Librarian, Head Library, Maharashtra National Law University, Nagpur, with us for the function. Again, it's my great privilege to introduce such a nice person, Dr. Lagdir Rabari. Dr. Lagdir Rabari is Master of Library and Information Science, Bachelor of Law, Master of Arts, PhD. He has earned diploma and certificates in intellectual property rights, cyber laws, and Tamil and Spanish languages. He has published many articles in journals and conferences, including in a vernacular language. He has authored one book, Indian Law Librarianship, University, Gandhinagar, as an assistant librarian, head of the library for 11 years. He also worked in Institute, Jain Vishwabharti Institute, Ludhiana, Rajasthan. He also worked for 1 year at Infibnet Center, Ahmedabad. He also worked at National Institute of Fashion Technology, Gandhinagar, for 1 year. He has organized 3 big events on DSpace, Koha, and 1 training program on law librarianship. He has attended many conferences and seminars and training program, including one at Bond University, Gold Coast, Australia. With this brief introduction, I request to Dr. Rabari sir to please share his view on this national webinar. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Prince Agashe sir. respected chairperson of this program and principal madam, Dr. Mehre, chief guest of this program, Dr. Prabhat Pandey, keynote addressee, Dr. Suresh Jange, resource person of this today's program, Dr. Anil Chikate, sir, and Dr. Shalini, madam. Dear participants and program convener, Rajesh Lokhande, and program organizing secretary, Prasanna Mool. Thank you for inviting me. Thank you for having me. And thank you to all participants for joining this national webinar on e-resources for academic excellence. Particularly focusing on unleashed and open access resources. Now everyone hear about the open school, open university, open education, open government, open publishing, open gym. Everything is open. And recently the government had introduced you open port also. Due to this COVID problem, the Gujarat High Court had started this court is a open court, not the all judges court as an open court, but just Chief Justice Court working as an open court. And I think that is a very good experience, particularly when the law school and law college students are asked to attend the court, how the court is working. So particularly for those students or even those learners, those who are not able to attend the court regularly, they can see court from their home, from their mobile. And particularly I have observed, because I had a dream to see the live court since many years, but due to some reason, I was not able to attend the courts. Since last 2 months, whenever I get a time, I attend that open court of the Gujarat. In this way. One thing I observed here, particularly talking about the open access resources and focusing on the unleashed resources, I heard from the welcome address given by the principal madam how enthusiastically academic faculty are working closely with the library. They know ki without the proper infrastructure, proper services, proper collaborations, and proper coordination with the library, their academic functions will not fulfill the requirement completely. So this is the one thing I've noted from the principal madam's welcome address. Then after this, today's chief guest, Dr. Prabhat Pandey, have given the good idea about the whole open access scenario in the library. And this today's the keynote addressee, Dr. Suresh Jange, has given the good idea that whether we library have a sufficient resources or not, we should continue to try to introduce, get those resources. But even in addition to this technology part, we librarians should always work as very closely with research, with the faculty members, with the student, by so welcoming heart. We always remain ready whenever any user comes in the library, how to embrace them, how to introduce them, how to guide them, how to assist them regarding the whatever resources available in our library. That is the one important thing noted by the speech of the keynote addressee. Then there was some good in detail academic technical session of Dr. Chakade sir and this Salini madam. Anil Chikate sir had given completely how the enlisted programming is working and what exactly the colleges are getting from the implement center on this online resources part. I say we librarians are so lucky that we have a good institute like the Implement working in Ahmedabad. And you can imagine how advanced they have envisaged the idea, the need of the library on the technology part. And Implement was started in 1991 as a part of the one project. And after that, continuously Implement is driving its activity for the benefit, for the development of the library. They developed good software for the library. They given the special grant to libraries for the automation purpose. There is a lot of training program are going on at Implement Center, lot of projects, e-consortia, and this is exclusively an endless program for the college library. As Dr. Anil sir has given the idea, what are the excellent resources they are providing to college library under the endless access? The resources from the Oxford, the resources from the JSTOR, the resources from the American Institute of Physics, and many more excellent resources are available under the NLIS program. And as he has given the list of number of colleges, number of institutes are registered under the NLIS program, that Maharashtra is at a top level. But here, when I was browsing the NLIS program yesterday from the ImpliNet website, I have noted one thing. There are the 25% institutes, they have not renewed their access. So I think when we are getting such good resources from the ImpliNet program, then we should not miss the renewal. I don't know whatever the reason these few colleges could not renew the access of the NLIS program. As if I see the subscription price, the membership is very not a costly. So that might be not a reason. But I request all the college librarian to just immediately renew our access of the NLIS program. Because when we are getting such wonderful resources, and it should not miss out from the our part. Now coming directly on the open access part, we librarians talk a lot about the how to access open access resources, how to list out those resources on our website so user can use it. But I want to give some point on the other part also. First, if we see the open access movement was started in the 2003 or 2005 onwards. There were the two very big events happened to push the open access movement in the world. One was the Budapest open access movement, and the second was the Berlin movement. The Budapest open access movement has given the good idea how libraries and institutes can work for the open access movement. Librarian can come together and they can develop the institutional repository. So whatever whatever resources are available under various institutes, they can develop the this platform to access for the open. Then they have also suggested to come together various libraries and publish the resources as open. And the third thing they suggest is ask the publisher to publish the few things as open access resources. Then the second movement was the Berlin Declaration to 2003, and the Berlin Declaration on Open Access Knowledge in the Science and Humanities of the 22nd October 2003 was one of the very good initiative in this part. Now, if I can say, what is the main objective of this open access movement? The first objective of open access movement is the bridging the gap between scholarly publications and the users. Our users should not suffer due to the limitation of the budget or limitation of the other technology. So whatever resources, whatever publication, whatever scientific output available in this world, all users should have a right to access those resources. And with this idea, with this objective, the open access movement has come. The second important point of this was the maintain the peer review standard. One thing comes into users' mind that when if anything is available open access, or if anything is available at the free of the cost, then there is no quality. But I think this is the wrong concept. If anyone have in the mind of the users, the open access resources are not maintaining the quality. That's absolutely wrong perceptions. Open access resources are also maintaining the good standard, because these open access resources are not coming out from any ordinary publications, but these resources also are coming out from the well-known publishers, just like Oxford and Cambridge, type of the resources. Now the thing I have noted, there is a one benefit on the user side, but on the other side also, the authors, publishers also see the one benefit on that part. Because any publications have a value when their access is more and more. If the access is less, then there is no use of such publication or no use of such research output or scientific output. So publisher are thinking, if we will keep our resources only on the commercial basis, and most of the libraries are public libraries, so there are many libraries that are not able to subscribe those commercial resources. And that is the users, they will not get more and more users. Because right now, most of the scientific research are measured, particularly academic research are measured based on the number of the users, number of the citations. If there is no user, if there is no access, then who will cite their articles? Who will cite their journals? So that is the one thing I have noted from the benefit of the publisher side, BAM, the benefit of the author side, why they also push more and more to give their content in the open access. Because they want more users, and we want for our users content. So I think there is a good combination in between. There is a good collaboration possibility in between the library part and on the academic part, on the publisher parts. So this is the one thing I have noted. And particularly for the library and information science department, I think they should increase more and more MLIC student and PhD student to just work on that part exactly. What is the exactly scenario working? That is not enough to just let out the open access resources on the library part, but we should more beyond try to develop the collaborative part with the faculty member, academicians, and publishers. And that is, I think, a good opportunity to take this moment further. Because whatever open access resources we see here, that is from the most of the from the foreign publication of the international publishers. The Indian librarian and Indian publisher need to do more work on that part. And that is, I think the librarian play a very important role to sensitize more and more publishers and more academicians to publish the content in the as open access resources. Otherwise, what happened, if I can give an example of my own resources, there is a possibility that most of the resources are, if there is a resources are available in the open access, there might be some aggregator will come, they will collect that all open access resources, they will put in one platform, and again they will sell as a subscription base, as a commercial base. So if we will not become very alert, conscious about all the thing which is available on the freely might be the same thing will be we have to pay and subscribe it. So this is the thing sometimes we observe in our content, because particularly for the law libraries, I have observed there are the many journals are published by that particular university or college as open access, but the same journals still available under any database as a subscription model. So the thing which I want to say, you might have understood very well. So this is the main benefit. This is the main alertness questions librarian need to do more and more research on this part, how the overall open access scenario is working, what is the standard, what is the copyright module, how the various copyright laws are working. This is the one point I have observed for the librarian. If I can give one important technical point for the publisher side, for the author point, the open access module work in two modules. One is the green publication, open publication, and another is the gold open access publications. So under the green open access publications, you can publish your own content, and you can put that content in your institutional repository as your open access, so anyone can access it. And under the gold publication, gold open access movement, the author asks a publisher to pay the maintenance fees of this particular articles, So when author will pay the maintenance cost of the particular article, then publisher will keep, publisher will put that article as an opener on that publication's website. Under this, there is one another module also they have developed. It's called the hybrid open access module. So when you submit any article with any publisher, the publisher will ask you whether you want to publish your article under the open access module or you want to publish your article under the commercial module. So if you will become agree with open access module, then publisher will ask again you to pay this maintenance publication cost and your article will be available in open access from that commercial publisher website also. So in this part, why am I want to remind this because the publication part is working directly from the academics sites. We librarian cannot do anything. But if we have some awareness, we have some understanding about this publication, open access publication scenario of the from the well-known publication, publisher, then definitely we can help, we can disseminate the information with the academic community, how you can publish your article under the open access movement. So definitely you will get the credit of your articles and the access will be given to open to all the users. And that is the reason if you have observed most of the even Oxford publication, Cambridge publication, Wiley publications, along with their commercial publication, there are some 10% or 15% content available as open access resources. So even if we list out those publisher website resources on our library page, so not all, but whatever publications are available on the open access, you will see that content in the green mark point. So our duty is not limited to list out only those freely available resources from the website, but we should find out, we should search from this well-known publisher website also. Out of that 100% content, whatever content available in the freely, under the freely. So whenever any users come in the library, if we try to search any content from the Oxford, Cambridge, Wiley, Sage, or any well-known publishers, because when we put any keyword in the on database, there are a lot many journals available. So out of the 100 journals or articles, definitely you will find 5 or 10 articles which are open. So there is not necessary to try to search the open access content exclusively from the open directory of open access journal or directory of open access books. But even you can search this open access content directly from the commercial publisher's website also. So this is very one good thing I have observed from the experience and feedback of the various users. So role of the librarian is very important, and particularly this webinar serve a good purpose to increase awareness among the librarians, increase the awareness among the users. And as said by me, increase awareness from the academic side also, how they can publish that article openly. So if academic will publish their article openly, then user will get the access of this article openly. So this is one thing I have observed. Because during one library program, similar program, I have observed the library subscribe to so many resources, but due to lack of the awareness, sometimes our faculty member or student, when they are doing any research, they try to search the content directly from the Google. Everything is not available under the Google on the freely. And when this faculty member or student sent request to library, librarians search the same content from the open access resources or resources subscribed by the libraries. Means everything was available under the library portal, under the subscribed content of the librarians. But there is some gap in between the awareness program of the librarian users and the faculty members. So sometimes we reach the maximum uses of the library content we subscribe in our library. So in that part, I think librarians should increase the orientation program, awareness program at every 6 months or every 3 months continuously. So at a one time, we cannot expect 100% participants will come from the library. But if the 10% will come in the library awareness program, then definitely at the span of the 1 year or 2 years, you will be able to cover the 100% library college users for this program. So with this, I'm not taking much time regarding the LLs. People have talked a lot about, and I have observed LLs is one of the really good open access initiative part. They are charging very limited membership fees and offering the one of the really good resources from the well-known publishers. So I think most of the college libraries should subscribe these. Those who have not renewed their NLIS program, they should renew the NLIS program immediately so their user can get the maximum benefit from that those resources. Along with these open access resources, I think again, if I can remind the libraries should give more and more assistance to our users, our faculty members, always get ready how to assist them. Even if I can say beyond, librarians should completely aware about the on which are the research area faculty are doing the research, on the which area the project work is going on, and the which area the student dissertation work is going on. You should invite to library users, students, or faculty member on the coffee table. You should discuss them openly under which area. And particularly for the during the literature review part, librarian play the very important role, sir. So my observation is, along with the whatever open access resources available, libraries plays beyond role and the fill the gap between whatever the users and the scholarly content available. I think library is the one of the important part to fill up this gap in this way. Thank you very much, Principal Madam and organizing committee, Lokhande sir and all the resource persons for giving me opportunity and to share my views on this part. Thank you to all.
Thank you very much, sir, for your nice talk. Now I over to Dr. Shailesh Bahadure, sir. Please, Shailesh Bahadure, sir.
Thank you very much, sir. From the entire talk of Rabbari, sir, what I got to know is a journey of several miles begins with a single step. And that is how we all should remind ourselves in the next days to come. We have been largely benefited by each and every word by Rabbari, sir. He serves a very nice institution, a national level institution here we have in Nagpur. It is just a matter of pride for all of us to have resources like Lakhvi Rabbari, sir, here. And we feel highly privileged to have you as one of the resource persons, though, you know, in a valedictory function, but your inputs have been very significant to each and every participant of this national webinar. I now request Mr. Rajesh Lokhande, sir, librarian, Dr. Ambedkar College, Dikshabhoomi, Nagpur, to have a formal vote of thanks to the entire proceedings of the national webinar today. Lokhande, sir.
Thank you, sir. Tathagat Gautam Buddha, our Bharat Ratna.
Thank you, Lakhvi, sir.
इनको विनम्र अभिवादन। अब हम इस वेबिनार की ज्ञानवर्धक सफर के अंतिम पड़ाव पर पहुंच गए। इस वेबिनार के प्रमुख अतिथि और रिसोर्स पर्सन, इन्होंने जो अमूल्य मार्गदर्शन किया, उसका फायदा हमें निश्चित तौर पर हमारे ग्रंथालयीन सेवाओं को बेहतर बनाने में होगा। इस वेबिनार की सफलता के लिए जिन्होंने प्रयास किया, उनका आभार व्यक्त करना हमारा कर्तव्य है। सर्वप्रथम परम पूज्य डॉक्टर बाबा साहब अम्बेडकर स्मारक समिति के अध्यक्ष आदरणीय भदंत आर्य नागार्जुन सुरेश ससाई जी, स्मारक समिति के सचिव आदरणीय डॉक्टर सुधीर पुंजेले सर, स्मारक समिति के सभी सम्माननीय सदस्य जो हमें इस तरह के आयोजन के लिए हमेशा प्रेरित करते हैं, मैं मनपूर्वक आप सभी का आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ। इस समारोह के प्रमुख अतिथि आदरणीय डॉक्टर प्रभात कुमार पांडे सर, जिन्होंने इस वेबिनार के प्रमुख अतिथि का आमंत्रण स्वीकार किया और हमें अमूल्य मार्गदर्शन किया, इसलिए महाविद्यालय की ओर से आपका मनपूर्वक आभार। इस समारोह के कीनोट स्पीकर आदरणीय डॉक्टर सुरेश जांगे सर, इनका मैं हृदय से आभार व्यक्त करना चाहता हूँ, जिन्होंने अपने व्यस्ततम दिनचर्या से वक्त निकालकर हमें अमूल्य मार्गदर्शन किया। धन्यवाद सर। इस समारोह के रिसोर्स पर्सन आदरणीय डॉक्टर अनिल चिकाटे सर, डॉक्टर शालिनी लिहितकर मैडम, समारोह समारंभ के प्रमुख अतिथि डॉक्टर लागदीर रब्बारी सर, इन सभी का मैं विशेष तौर पर आभार व्यक्त करना चाहता हूँ। आपने हम सभी को ज्ञानवर्धक मार्गदर्शन किया और अच्छा कार्य करने के लिए प्रेरित किया। धन्यवाद सर, धन्यवाद। इस समारोह के चेयरपर्सन और महाविद्यालय की प्राचार्य आदरणीय डॉक्टर बी ए मेहरे मैडम, जिन्होंने इस वेबिनार के आयोजन के लिए महत्वपूर्ण भूमिका निभाई, मैं मनपूर्वक आपका आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ। डॉक्टर शैलेश बहादुरे सर, डॉक्टर अजय कुमार आगाशे सर, श्री आतिश मेश्राम सर, डॉक्टर रामदास लीतकर सर, डॉक्टर अनिता तिरपुड़े मैडम, डॉक्टर प्रतिमा लोखंडे मैडम, डॉक्टर मोहन वानखेड़े सर, डॉक्टर अविनाश फुलजले सर, डॉक्टर गौतम कांबड़े सर, इनका मैं हृदय से आभार व्यक्त करना चाहता हूँ, जिन्होंने इस समारोह के सफलता के लिए अथक प्रयास किया। इस नेशनल वेबिनार के ऑर्गेनाइजिंग सेक्रेटरी श्री प्रसन्न मूल सर, वेबिनार एडवाइजरी कमेटी के सभी सम्माननीय सदस्य, महाविद्यालय के सभी उप प्राचार्य, बैक कोऑर्डिनेटर डॉक्टर हेमा मेनन मैडम, इन सभी का मैं आयोजन को सफल बनाने में उनके अमूल्य योगदान के लिए मनपूर्वक आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ। महाविद्यालय के सभी प्राध्यापक वर्ग, शिक्षकेतर कर्मचारी, टेक्निकल एक्सपर्ट श्री आशीष मोरासकर, श्री कमलेश खैरकर, ग्रंथालय विभाग के सभी कर्मचारी, इन सभी का मैं महाविद्यालय की ओर से मनपूर्वक आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ। इस नेशनल वेबिनार से जुड़े देश के विभिन्न राज्यों के सभी पार्टिसिपेंट्स, जिन्होंने इस वेबिनार में सहभागी होकर इसे सफल बनाया, मैं महाविद्यालय की ओर से सभी का मनपूर्वक हार्दिक आभार व्यक्त करता हूँ। और समारोपीय कार्यक्रम के अध्यक्ष की अनुमति से इस नेशनल वेबिनार का समापन हुआ ऐसा घोषित।